The floor for Bowling Green, this time at home within the walls of the Stroh Center. Chella Watson and the Buffalo Bulls have come into town to take on the red-hot Bowling Green Falcons, led by Amy Velasco. Hello, everybody. Welcome in once again. Brandon Lowe back with you here. The guy to my left tonight, Camden Orth, one of the QBs for Bowling Green football. So, Cam, joining the booth with us tonight. And, Cam, we're expecting a good one, a showdown between these teams, both fighting for seeding in the Mid-American Conference Tournament. In a tie right now, but Buffalo holds the tiebreaker in that four seed. But whoever wins tonight will clinch their spot in the Mid-American Conference Tournament.
Yeah, honestly, Brandon, it's going to be a good one. Both teams are trending up right now. Bowling Green obviously going 2-0 last week, and Buffalo getting the win last week versus Ohio.
And that's the thing. These two teams come in very similar situations. Buffalo on the season, 15-10, 8-6 in the Mid-American Conference. Bowling Green on the other side, they're 14-11, just one behind. You could argue that Bowling Green had a tougher non-conference schedule, which they did by far, but 8-6 in the Mid-American Conference there as well. But you kind of said it right there, Bowling Green. They went on the road last week. They took two wins, one over Akron, one over Northern Illinois, and it was a really good week for the Falcons to come away with wins in what were two relatively close games. But for Buffalo, on the other side, they've lost two of their last three, so that last game against Ohio in a 13-point victory was really critical for them.
Yeah, 100%. I mean, you know, obviously at this time of the year, you want to start, like I said earlier, trending up and winning games, and losing three in a row coming to a big game like this would have been pretty demoralizing for them. So I think getting that win last week was huge for them, and then obviously it's another big one tonight.
Indeed it is. Again, that four seed will be determined tonight. Not locked officially, but it gives either one of these teams, whichever wins, it gives that team an upper hand. Certainly both would like to have the upper hand with just three games to go after tonight. And these are two teams that have already played once this season. That one came back Wednesday, January 24th, so just a little bit over a month ago.
Yeah, so obviously the Falcons lost by 10, 72-82 that game. I think a lot of it contributed to the came down a lot to free throws, and turnovers. Bowling Green obviously have 12 turnovers, Buffalo only having five, and then with the free throws, Bowling Green shot 44%, while Buffalo shot nearly 90.
And that's going to be something we talk about throughout the night. Each time one of these teams gets to the line, free throws so crucial in close games, and it seems like when we get to this time of the year, late February, early March, it can come down to a point, few points, but a point, and every free throw at the line counts. In Bowling Green, that's been something they've really had to work on over the last number of weeks, is trying to improve their free throw percentage. And then plus, in that game back in the end of January, Chella Watson exploded for 36 points, which is one of the top 10 individual single game scoring performances for this Buffalo team in program history. Two of those have come against Bowling Green, by the way. One from Chella Watson earlier this year, and then one from De'Asia Fair when she scored 40 here back in the Stroh Center. But that kind of just leads us into some keys about these teams. And when we talk about keys, Bowling Green, and Fred Shamil said it himself this week on the coaches segment, which you can check out on the BG Athletics Twitter or X, whichever you call it, page. Also, you can find it on Falcon Media Sports Network's page as well. But he said they need to be playing better defensively, and they have had quarters this year where they've stepped up. But the key to, you know, transitioning and having good offense, you got to get some stops at the other end.
Yep, exactly. I mean, first of all, like you said, Chella, I mean, 36 points. You shut down 36 points. I mean, they're out of the game completely. And then you talk about stopping her, and you get the ball more, the opportunity to score more, and then from there on out, it's just looking good for BG.
And then on the other side for Buffalo, you have to figure out how to capitalize on that momentum. Chella Watson spent some time where she was a little bit banged up, still has played every game, but she spent some time off the floor where she was playing limited minutes due to an injury that she suffered a couple of weeks ago. Talked to Jack Cruiser, the play-by-play guy for this Buffalo team, and he said she's back 100% healthy, so how can she manage what Bowling Green will throw at her defensively? We've seen it. She's a smart player. She's been around the game for a long time, and she's also the Mid-American Conference leader in points per game.
Yeah, I'm seventh in the country in scoring, like you said. Last game, 36 points, averaging 23, and obviously more than 25 in conference, so she's definitely going to be someone to stop.
So when we look to impact players, certainly Watson, for Buffalo is going to be the player to watch. The redshirt senior came over from USC upstate with Coach Becky Burke, and she sat out last year, has taken the momentum and the experience this year and ran with it here in the Mid-American Conference. Had 47 against Toledo earlier this season, 47 against the number one seed in the Mid-American Conference right now. If that's not saying I can get the job done, I don't know what is.
Brandon, you're exactly right. And I think another person to look out for is a candidate, possibly along with Paige Kohler, is Kirsten Lewis-Williams.
Kirsten Lewis-Williams, another one of those. She averaged, or she, her season high was 22 points back at Akron earlier this season, but also averages just about 12 points a game. And that's going to be, you know, one of the guards that Bowling Green, or that one of the guards, excuse me, that Buffalo looks to. The 5'10 freshman has stepped up, and you kind of alluded, you mentioned Paige Kohler in that comment as well. Those two are going to be two that are very well in that freshman of the year conversation in a couple of weeks before we get to Cleveland. So Kirsten Lewis-Williams, certainly one to watch out for Buffalo. On the other side, again, we got to mention Morgan Sharp surpasses 1,000 career points last week in the first of the two games on the road to Akron. But Amy Velasco had herself a week. Mid-American Conference Player of the Week came out yesterday and averaged 25 points over the two games last week, including a new career high 32 points at Northern Illinois.
Yeah, Brandon, last game marked her fourth 20-point performance in, just for this season alone. I mean, she needs another big game this game. Last game versus Buffalo, she had 16 points, 4 rebounds, 11 assists, so she's going to need another big one tonight.
And Velasco is somebody that Coach Fred Shamil said has gotten better every day. Every day she's in the gym, she's getting better at something. And Amy, certainly playing her best basketball at the right time of the year, has stepped up for this Bowling Green team. And shooting the three-point ball at a remarkable 43% from the floor, was 4 of 9 last time out. And she's not the highest volume shooting three-point shooter on this team. That one goes to Morgan Sharps. But Velasco, when she gets that three-point shot, it seems like it has been consistent. And 43% from behind the arc is remarkable.
It is. It truly is. I mean, Morgan, Amy are both shooting at an extremely high rate, 38% for Morgan. 43%, like you said, from Amy. If they can keep up those numbers, it'll be hard to stop them tonight.
So we will look to keep our eyes on the junior from Centerville as our impact player to watch. And just, we have a couple more minutes here before we go into the pregame ceremonies, pregame festivities, whatever you want to call them here at the Stroh Center before we get this one going. Your overall thoughts on what we're going to see tonight between these two teams?
I'd like to see a great defensive performance from the Falcons, being able to stop Chella, and just for the Falcons to be able to get to the stripe and knock them down and play a good game, and then obviously the rebounds from Erica Porter to really take over.
And that, you know, you mentioned a key thing there for Porter. You know, she averages 6 rebounds a game, but you look down this lineup for the Buffalo Bulls, and everybody averages, all 5 starters, well, they changed their starting lineup a little bit tonight, which we'll get to in a moment, but the 5 starters from last game all average over 5 rebounds a game, some over 6, so it's really a team that has a lot of rebounders. They know how to get to the boards, they know how to get second chance points, and Bowling Green, they're going to have to stop that, and we've seen Erica Porter with double-doubles, double figures in the rebounding department, including earlier this season, 19, when they went down and played Miami in Oxford. But when you're going up against a team with a lot of size that knows how to bring the basketball down and get rebounds, you're going to look to your leading rebounder to step up, and that's what we're going to have to see Erica Porter do tonight.
100%. Erica, along with, I think, a sleeper rebounder, is Paige Kohler. She's second on the team with 93 defensive rebounds, so I think it's going to be big for her to stay involved on the defensive boards tonight, along with Erica, which since the start of 2024, she's averaged 7.5 a game.
Erica Porter has stepped up in Mid-American Conference play. Well, we have a big-time Mid-American Conference matchup coming up in just a couple of minutes. Now we will step aside for the pregame festivities. We've got the number 4 Buffalo Bulls and the number 5 Bowling Green Falcons fighting for seeding. This game counts after tonight. Just 3 to go before we get to the conference tournament in Cleveland. We will step aside when we come back. Starting lineups and more here. You're listening to Bowling Green Women's Basketball right here on 88.1 WBGU.
Wake up every weekday with WBGU in the morning show. The Morning Show is a community resource for weekly events, news, sports, weather, interviews with community officials and organizations, birthday and anniversary announcements, and more. Listen live every weekday from 6 a.m. to 9 a.m. locally on 88.1 FM or streaming online at bgfalconmedia.com.
All the talks we've had over the years, including what you've told me about not using alcohol and other drugs, they stick with me. And believe it or not, they really do make a difference, especially at times that matter most.
Hey, want a drink?
No thanks, I'm good. So thank you, Dad, for talking and preparing me for what's ahead.
Thank you for talking.
For more information about talking with your kids about underage use of alcohol and other drugs, visit underagedrinking.samhsa.gov.
If you suffer from COPD symptoms like shortness of breath and fatigue, where do you turn? There are medications and oxygen, but do you know about pulmonary rehab? 3 out of 5 COPD patients have never heard of it. Pulmonary rehab is an exercise, education, and support program that gives you tools to manage your condition, and Medicare typically pays for it. So whether it's grocery shopping on your own or just walking across the room, pulmonary rehab can help you. Visit livebetter.org to find out about your options for pulmonary rehab today.
Hi, it's Olivia Munn with my shelter pets, Frankie and Chance. Say hi, guys. When I adopted them, I discovered that they both have incredible personalities. Chance's sole purpose in life is to love and to be loved. Frankie is a little bit of a scoundrel and always entertaining. They're a little bit of a lot of things, but they're all pure love. Adopt pure love at theshelterpetproject.org. Brought to you by the Ad Council, the Humane Society of the United States, and Maddie's Fund.
Some knowledge belongs to us and us alone. The way our girlfriends walk, talk, touch their hair. Details that only a sister can know about her girls. But what about our other girls? The ones we carry with us every day. Our bond with our sister girls gives life. But knowing your breasts can save it. Go to knowyourgirls.org for the facts you need on breast health. Brought to you by Susan G. Komen and the Ad Council.
Melissa from Michigan. I work an extra part-time job serving lunch at my child's school, but I still can't afford to put food on our table.
Daniel from California. Choosing whether to pay the rent or pay to fix the car to get to work doesn't leave us with much at all. Now we can't even pay for meals.
Hunger is a story we can end. End it at feedingamerica.org. Brought to you by Feeding America and the Ad Council.
This is Artie Abrego, and you're listening to 88.1 FM WBGU Bowling Green, home of the Falcon Media Sports Network.
Did you know that people born from 1945 to 1965 have the highest rates of hepatitis C, but most don't know they're infected? People can live for decades without symptoms, but over time, hepatitis C can cause serious health problems, including liver damage and even liver cancer. If you were born from 1945 to 1965, the CDC recommends that you get a blood test for hepatitis C. So talk to your doctor about getting tested. It could save your life. A message from the CDC.
All over America, people are taking the national radon test. Have you? Answer true or false. Radon is a radioactive gas. True.
I didn't know that, no.
True or false. The Office of the Surgeon General recommends that all homes be tested for radon. True, your home should be tested. True or false, radon is the second leading cause of lung cancer. True.
I'm going to dial the number and call.
1-800-SOS-RADON.
Keep your family safe from radon. Call now.
1-800-SOS-RADON.
Women Heart is in a race to save lives. Heart disease is the number one killer of women. It's 80% preventable if you know the facts. Millions of women are living with or at risk of heart disease. Get educated. See your doctor. Know the facts. To win this race, we all have to do it together. Our hearts beat as one. To learn more, visit womenheart.org.
Well, we are back inside the Stroh Center, approaching opening tip-off. Brandon Lowe, Cam Orth back with you here on behalf of BG Falcon Media, Falcon Media Sports Network, bringing you another presentation of Bowling Green women's basketball. So let's get into the starting lineups tonight. First for the visiting Buffalo Bulls, they'll go with the 5'3 senior out of Dearborn, Michigan, Rena El Husseini. The 5'10 freshman out of Mooresville, North Carolina, Kirsten Lewis-Williams. The grad student standing at 6'2 out of Buffalo, New York, Kiara Johnson. The 6-foot freshman once again, two freshmen in this starting lineup for Buffalo. This time it'll be Alexis Davis out of Woodbury, New Jersey, and rounding out the starting lineup, of course, our player to watch for Falcon Media Sports Network here in this one, the 5'8 redshirt senior from Winder, Georgia, number 35, Chella Watson. On the other side for Bowling Green, the same starting lineup back once again. The 5'10 fifth year out of Granville, Ohio, Morgan Sharps. The 5'7 junior out of Centerville, Ohio, Amy Velasco, coming off her MAC Player of the Week honors. The 5'8 freshman out of Olmsted Falls, Paige Kohler. The 6-foot senior out of Palatine, Illinois, Olivia Hill. And the 6-foot senior out of West Windsor, New Jersey, number 32, Erica Porter. So Bowling Green and Buffalo set to go, both going through things one last time. Buffalo going to go with their road blues white trim. And Bowling Green, they will trot out as well in their home whites with the orange trim and orange numbering. So we are just about ready to go. 10 minutes loaded up on the board. Alexis Davis walks to the timeline. Getting ready to kick things off. The Bulls just awaiting the Falcons to come out on the floor, and here they come, the first one off the bench. Amy Velasco, the newest Mid-American Conference Player of the Week. And you know, we've talked throughout the course of the year about second quarter being an area where Bowling Green, in terms of offense, has sometimes struggled. But this Buffalo team, they've had their struggles of their own in the second quarter as well so far this year. Just 2 points out in the second quarter, last time out at Ohio, and that was on a fast break off a turnover. So we'll see what the first half has in store for these two foes tonight. Alexis Davis and Erica Porter at the timeline, ready for opening tip, and we are underway. Ball straight up in the air. Bowling Green going to get it first. Went right off into the hands of Olivia Hill. Hands back to Velasco. Velasco settles in here. Works out to the right side. Kohler makes a run under the basket. Back on the perimeter. It stays. Kohler comes out to it. The freshman out on the right wing. Looking for an avenue. Looking for somewhere to move. Ball back into the hands of Velasco at the top of the key. Going to go back to the right. Bounce pass off. Here's Kohler once again. Trying to get inside over the top of Lewis Williams. Left it just short off the front of the iron there. Here comes El Husseini in transition for Buffalo. Over on the right side, just in front of the Bowling Green bench, El Husseini the basketball, looking for an outlet pass. Lewis Williams calling forward in the corner. Now she'll come out and take the basketball well away from the perimeter, beyond the top of the key. El Husseini goes corner to corner on the baseline. Chella Watson going to sling the three right away. That one was smooth as it finds its way through the cup.
She's not afraid to shoot that. She's been shooting every game. She's going to keep shooting them.
Amy Velasco now the ball for Bowling Green, and Buffalo scores first in this one. So they will start with a 3-point lead just over a minute in now. Velasco back off to Sharps. Sharps not afraid to shoot the three ball either. We'll see how long it takes her before she takes her first look at the basket. A little pitch pass off to Paige Kohler, barreling through the lane on the right side here over the top of Lewis Williams. Too much on it. Going to get a foul called on the floor. Looks like it's going to be assessed to Alexis Davis, and it is.
We're going to get as many second chance points as we can. The Falcons can. It's going to be a huge one tonight.
So Velasco will inbound from the baseline here. Gets it into Hill. Here comes Kohler around the outside. Guarded by Watson off the Sharps. Thought about a three. Off the pump fake. Had to keep it in terms of being locked down defensively. It was 2-on-1 there. Here comes Velasco under 10 on the shot clock. Inside. Tries the floater out of the right hand. It's last touch before going out of bounds by Porter. Wanted a tip on Kiara Johnson. Not going to get it that time.
Again, even though Bowling Green came out with no points, having second chance points is going to be huge for every single possession. If they get more than one opportunity, it's going
to
be huge.
And the key to those second chance points is something we talked about in the pregame show. Of course, rebounding. Here's Watson on the outside once again, moving in from the right elbow. Left that one short. Basketball comes back out. This time it's Buffalo with an offensive board. Watson going to move it out to the left. Not a ton on the pass, but it did find the fingertips of Lewis Williams at the bottom of her reach. El Husseini back to Lewis Williams. Bowling Green in the zone right now. Watson tries to spin a pass off to El Husseini. There's another three straight away. El Husseini knocks it down. The Bulls back-to-back threes to get this one going. 2-10 in.
El Husseini 34% so far from the three this year.
So 6-0 Buffalo. Bowling Green still looking for their first bucket of the game. Porter finds a nice back cutting pass to Morgan Sharps, and Sharps gets a layup there. Not what we see from her a ton in terms of going inside, but Morgan Sharps gets the Falcons started here with a nice layup. Buffalo back with the basketball. El Husseini looking down low. Johnson trying to get around Porter, puts it up. It rolls off the rim. Hill there with a rebound off the hands of Sharps. Kohler able to pick it up as that one made its way towards the out-of-bounds line. Sharps for threes. Couldn't hit the tone on that one. Davis there for the rebound. Hill was in there as well. A little bit of contact made between those two. Here comes Watson up the floor, controlling the basketball with a left hand. Off to El Husseini now. Fires down low. Lewis Williams, baseline jumper here. Off the back iron. Kohler with a rebound. Paige Kohler bringing it up off the Sharps. They put it into the hands of a junior guard. Amy Velasco tied up there. Jump ball. Possession arrow goes with Buffalo. So Buffalo off to a hot start here. Back-to-back threes at the offensive end, and they've forced some miscues on Bowling Green's offensive end. So here come El Husseini and Lewis Williams over the timeline together. El Husseini throws to the left, plays a game of catch with Watson. Now down low, Davis gets by Porter, picks up two there. It's 8-2 Buffalo, 3.5 minutes into this one.
Bowling Green's got to come up with a big stop next time and get some points down this on his possession.
Velasco looking to Porter at the right elbow, gives off to Kohler. Bowling Green, you can tell, trying to get the basketball inside right now. Buffalo's defense just too much for him. Sharps on the left wing, back to Kohler. Kohler, long three ball, straight away here. Knocks it down, does Paige Kohler.
25% from three on the year. Pretty impressive she came and shot that straight off the bounce, just got it in.
Three-point percentage has gotten better over the last couple of weeks for Paige Kohler, who shot 2 of 4 last time out against Northern Illinois. Buffalo going to answer right back as Alexis Davis knocks one down from the left elbow. 10-5, Bowling Green has cut into the lead, but it is still a two-possession game. Sharps on the outside, working the right wing. Tight defense there from El Husseini. Porter just beyond the free throw line, tries that pass down low to a driving Morgan Sharps once again. But that one too far out in front of Sharps. It will go out of bounds for a turnover.
Like we said in the pregame show, 12 turnovers last time the Bowling Green Falcons played Buffalo. So they're already at 2, so if they can keep that down to about 3 or less per quarter, then they should be all right. Obviously hate to see it at all.
Sophie Zekin inside for Bowling Green, checking in for Erica Porter, the first substitution of the game. Here's El Husseini outside for Buffalo. Has some separation, tried to go off the glass there. Went over the top of the bucket and came back down. But able to get a steal at the other end is El Husseini. Ripped it out of the hands of Paige Kohler as Kohler came up the floor. The freshman trying to get back to defend. El Husseini the basketball out to Watson. Here comes a three once again. That one, not the note. Amy Velasco picks up the rebound and heads north for Bowling Green. Paige Kohler outside with Velasco. The tandem of Sharps, Velasco, and Kohler continues to work the ball around the perimeter. Kohler going to be the one to take it inside. Travel going to be calm. We hear the whistle blow, and that will take us to the first quarter media timeout. One of our timeouts brought to you by Juniper Brewing Company, located at 145 South Main Street in downtown Bowling Green, featuring coffee and craft beer, serving breakfast, lunch, and dinner. See the latest menu at juniperbrew.com. Buffalo leads Bowling Green 10-5. We will step aside. You're listening to Bowling Green Women's Basketball right here on 88.1 WBGU.
Don't miss the morning show on WBGU FM every weekday from 6 to 9 a.m. Join the morning show team weekday mornings to hear about local news, local weather report, Glatz Garden report, coaches show with the coaches from BGSU and BGHS, and live newsmaker interviews. Listen live every weekday from 6 to 9 a.m. locally on 88.1 FM or streaming online at bgfalconmedia.com.
Falcon men's basketball faces off against the Miami Redhawks on Tuesday, February 27th. Join FMSN's Tyler Cavalitz and Chaz McNeil on the call at 6:45 for pregame and 7 p.m. for tip-off. Catch the high-flying action on 88.1 FM WBG.
The average time a resume spends on an HR manager's desk is 7 seconds, and most of them are tossed aside. Now imagine if one of those resumes belonged to Yasmin, who was
living in a shelter, juggling 3 jobs. I had to be resilient. That's something that you can't teach.
We rely so much on a resume, yet it could never tell the full story of someone who
had to be independent and take initiative, and that's how I handle every project I get.
Discover new ways to develop great talent at gradsoflife.org. Brought to you by Grads of Life and the Ad Council.
Welcome back to The Dog Show. Up next, we have Satchmo. Satchmo is a member of the Shelter Pet Group.
That's right, a group known especially for their couch-snuggling, ball-chasing, face-licking, and, of course, companionship. Now, let's see him in action.
Look how he makes eye contact with his person.
That's actually known as the treat stare.
How intuitive, and now he appears to be excitedly turning in circles.
Ah, the happy dance will come in with this group.
But really, the best way to know an amazing shelter pet like Satchmo is to meet one.
Visit theshelterpetproject.org today. Adopt.
Brought to you by Maddie's Fund, the Humane Society of the United States, and the Ad Council.
Brandon Lowe, Cam Orth back with you here on behalf of Falcon Media Sports Network. Out of the first quarter media timeout, 4:53 left to play in the first. Buffalo leads Bowling Green 10-5 right now. And Cam, you said off there, one of the things that you noticed during that first portion of the first quarter, Buffalo extremely active at both ends of the floor.
They are, Brandon, especially on the defensive end. They're sliding their feet. They're super aggressive. They got a lot of backside help with on Erica Porter. And right now they're a little too much for Bowling Green.
Bowling Green right now shooting 2 of 6 to start in this one. Buffalo 4 of 9. Buffalo does have the basketball here out of the timeout. El Husseini leading the floor for the Bulls once again. Working out to the right side. Hattie Ogden into the contest now. Started last game. Johnson got the nod tonight instead. And a double dribble going to be called for there on Cello Watson, who comes up with a surprised look on her face.
Yeah. I didn't think she double dribbled, but not my job.
Neither did she.
Yeah.
So here come Hill and Velasco out of the backcourt for Bowling Green. Velasco gets rid of the basketball off into the hands of Zeke, and here's Kohler on the outside once again. The freshman working the perimeter, looking down low, wanted to go to Zeke and instead has to bring it back out for Sharps. The Bulls keeping the Falcons on the perimeter right now. Foul going to be called there. It will go on Alexis Davis. That's Davis's second foul of the game.
If they can get Alexis Davis in some foul trouble, she averages 6 rebounds a game. That would be huge for the Falcons.
Alexis Davis is the only one with a foul so far in this game, and she's actually got 2 of them, so Buffalo will go ahead. Becky Burke going to pull the trigger and bring Kiara Johnson back in. So Velasco on the baseline, looking in, got it in to Zekin. Zekin trying to get by Johnson under the basket, brings it back out. Velasco, a 3-point try. That one off left. Hill, an offensive rebound, fires it back out. Kohler beyond the perimeter, slowing things down. Heels in that center court logo. The state of Ohio with that BG emblem on the floor here. On Bill Frack court. Velasco trying to thread the needle and get it back into Sharps. It was knocked away there. Here comes El Husseini up the floor once again. Gets it to Lewis Williams. Sharps able to get the body in front and force Lewis Williams back beyond the perimeter once again. El Husseini moves the ball off to Watson. Watson's taken 2 looks from deep here in this one. Instead, sheds that basketball off as she was driving inside. Ogden down low. Lewis Williams lost the basketball out of bounds. It will be the Bulls basketball, so it'll stay at this end of the floor.
Falcons got to find some efficiency on offense. Too many turnovers right now.
10-5 still to score. Both teams scoreless for the last 2.5-plus minutes. Lewis Williams takes the inbound pass. Here's Johnson off to Ogden. Cello Watson coming open at the top of the key. Steps back. 3-point try once again at the horn. Could not get it there, but had to get the basketball off to avoid the shot clock violation. Velasco up the right side. Off to Sharps. Sharps catch and shoot this time. And that one will go out of bounds. Zekin trying to save it. Trying to save the basketball and stay out of the laps of the front row videography and media staff from various outlets here for Bowling Green, filming the game tonight. Could not keep the basketball in. 3:10 left to play in the first. Still that scoreless stretch that's now over 3 minutes for Bowling Green, approaching 3 minutes for Buffalo. Lewis Williams going to bring the basketball up the floor this time. A different look than what we've seen so far. It's been El Husseini for the first 7 minutes. Now Ogden going to try her hand at a three, and Hattie Ogden lets that one rain down. And Buffalo, just like that, strong from three to start. 3 of 5, shooting 60% from beyond the perimeter. And that's something that Bowling Green has had to deal with for their last three games. Akron shot 12 of 25 from behind the three-point line last Wednesday. Northern Illinois started 5 of 7 from behind the arc in the game on Saturday. And Buffalo, a hot start here. Kohler with the basketball on offense for Bowling Green. Down under 10 on the shot clock. Going inside, the freshman left it short. Zekin able to get back to the basketball. Has it ripped away after her chance at it. Shot clock violation there. It'll be Buffalo basketball.
Yeah, Zekin's not the same offensive presence that Erica Porter has, but she definitely is scrappy, and I think that's a lot what the Falcons need right now in the rebound game.
And Erica Porter will come right back in for Bowling Green. That has been the one swap that the Falcons have made. Paola Lopez in for Buffalo as well. Lewis Williams standing well back beyond the perimeter now. Now working inside. Kicks out. Ogden going to get another open three-point try once again. That one off the rim into the baseline. Out of bounds it goes. Bowling Green will take over.
Kind of want to see Morgan Sharps get past the ball in this, get some off-ball screens, get her open shot. Shooting 38% from the three this year. Like to see her get going.
Kohler looking to Morgan Sharps right now. Guarded by Lewis Williams. Buffalo's defense staying tight on that trio on the outside. Kohler looking to find an avenue to open things up. Velasco trying to go inside as well. Back out, it's the freshman. Now Morgan Sharps has the basketball on the right side. Here's Velasco once again trying to get around Lopez. And a foul going to be called. It will go against Watson. So Cello Watson hit with her first foul call of the game.
Yeah, Buffalo's doing a great job of switching off on this three-man weave they're trying to do, Bowling Green.
So Velasco will inbound. Kohler comes back to take the basketball. Little back and forth here again. Sharps, little pump fake. Watson right in her face. Gets the pass to Kohler instead. Kohler tangled up inside. Velasco back to Sharps. Open three. Morgan Sharps rattles it home. Could that be the kickstart that Bowling Green is looking for after over 4 minutes scoreless?
She's averaging 15 points a game, which is first on the team right now. So to get her going would be huge.
13-8, Buffalo leads. 1:10 left in the first quarter. El Husseini going after a three for Buffalo at the other end and hit it. Buffalo has doubled up Bowling Green here early. 1 minute to play in the first quarter. 16-8, Bulls lead the Falcons. Sharps on the outside once again. Kohler thought she set her up, just not enough space. That's been the theme of the night for Bowling Green on offense. Here's Hill in the corner, going after the three. Too long. Porter able to get a hand to it and grabs the offensive rebound. Foul going to be called as well. Rena El Husseini tried to get in there and strip the basketball away. Too much contact for the liking of this official crew.
I like the way that Bowling Green's starting to play. They're starting to play a lot more physical than they were in the beginning of the game, which I think will definitely be a positive thing for them.
And I believe they're going to go over to the monitor and look at this one to see if there was any intentional contact from Porter there, any unnecessary contact from Erica Porter. We will have to see if that's what they're indeed looking at. So with 44.2 left in the quarter, a brief paused so that the officials can go look at the replay and monitor. 16-8, the Bulls lead. Let's take a short break with them here. You're listening to Bowling Green Women's Basketball right here on 88.1 WBGU.
The possibility of lung cancer can be pretty scary, especially if you're one of approximately 8 million current or former smokers at high risk. That's why SaveByTheScan.org wants you to know that now there's a breakthrough low-dose CT scan that can detect lung cancer early, and it only takes 60 seconds. You stop smoking, now start screening. For an easy quiz to see if you're eligible, visit SaveByTheScan.org. It could save your life. SaveByTheScan.org is brought to you by the American Lung Association's Lung Force Initiative and the Ad Council.
Back here at the Stroh Center, so nothing out of the break. So evidently no unnecessary contact deemed there for Erica Porter. Bowling Green will have the basketball after the foul to Rena El Husseini. Buffalo four fouls so far in this first quarter. Bowling Green has not fouled yet. Morgan Sharps gives the basketball away right into the hands of Kirsten Lewis-Williams. Coming up the floor one-on-one, Lewis-Williams too much on the bunny. Could not get it. Now the shot clock is off, and Bowling Green can hold for the last shot if they want to. Velasco here. Basketball still in hand, 15 on the clock. Buffalo leads by 8, 16-8. Inside Porter, right elbow, gives back off to Kohler. Had some separation, but not enough. Chella Watson comes out to defend. Here's Kohler looking inside. Down low, finds Porter off the glass. Erica Porter gets two. Lewis Williams up the floor, and time will expire on the first quarter. So Bowling Green finds themselves behind after the first quarter. Buffalo's defense translates into offense just like we talked about. The Bulls lead the Falcons 16-10 at the first quarter break. You're listening to Bowling Green Women's Basketball right here on 88.1 WBGU.
We are live outside the home of Joe and Rosie Goddard, where a pretty big tickle fight broke out just minutes ago. Sources say their father instigated the laughter. Let's go inside for a comment. Apparently, they have no comment. Dads, let this be a reminder that it only takes a moment to make a moment. Call 877-4DAD-411 or visit fatherhood.gov. Brought to you by the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services and the Ad Council.
BGSU women's basketball, Morgan Sharps, the fifth-year senior guard from Granville, Ohio, is hoping to have a big year after missing most of last season with a knee injury. Sharps attended Xavier University after finishing her high school career at Newark. After two seasons, she decided to transfer to Bowling Green. In Sharps' first season at BG, she averaged 9.5 points per game, 1.9 rebounds per game, and hit a BG's best 72 three-pointers. The 2022-23 season ended early for Sharps as she sustained a knee injury in mid-January that ended her season. After missing the first few games of the season, Sharps made her debut against Lehigh on November 23rd. In her first game action in over 9 months, she had 15 points, 3 rebounds, and 3 steals versus the Mountain Hawks. This has been 60 Seconds in Falcons Athletics on 88.1 FM, WBGU, Northwest Ohio's community radio station.
In the wake of a disaster, what one thing can you send that will help people the most? A blanket, a tent, a sandbag, a doctor. Actually, if you send a monetary donation, you send all these things. Even a small donation can make a big impact and can quickly become exactly what people affected by disaster need most.
In the wake of a hurricane, your monetary donation can make a huge difference to those in need. To donate, visit supporthurricanerelief.org. That's supporthurricanerelief.org. Brought to you by the Ad Council.
Back here at the Stroh Center after one quarter of play, Buffalo has the lead 16-10. Brandon Lowe and Cam Orth back with you here on behalf of Falcon Media Sports Network. And some things are going to have to change for Bowling Green moving forward in this one. And you notice some of the changes that they might have to make here moving forward.
First of all, I would say just turning the ball over on offense. I mean, 7 turnovers in the first quarter. Last time they played Buffalo, they had 12 at the end of the game. So 7 in the first quarter, definitely need to cut down those turnovers.
So Paige Kohler will inbound to Amy Velasco to get this second quarter started here. We'll see if Bowling Green can lock in. They had an over 4 minute scoreless stretch at one point in the first quarter. We'll see what the Falcons have drawn up here during the break to try to translate to some points on the scoreboard. Morgan Sharps on the outside after a pass from Velasco. Foul going to be called down low. It'll be an offensive foul away from the basketball. It'll go on Erica Porter. And Erica Porter, a player for Bowling Green, that you kind of got to watch what she does in terms of her fouls, because she's not the person you want to have in foul trouble. I mean, even you notice right away off the top of the broadcast that Erica Porter is a very, you know, valuable interior presence. Lewis Williams misses the interior post chance at the other end. Bowling Green. Velasco the feed to Kohler. Kohler inside finds Morgan Sharps wide open. You know she's not missing those. Morgan Sharps makes it a one-score game. El Husseini off to Lewis Williams trying to go inside. Velasco knocks away the basketball. Porter on the floor along with Velasco. The two collided there. Both have smiles on their faces as they come up the floor now, as they make it back to their feet. Kohler calls out the play. Working from right to left, off to Velasco here, chest pass. Ball in the right hand of Velasco. Sharps moving, trying to get open. Velasco trying to get inside, ball still loose. Bowling Green able to come up with an offensive rebound. Velasco working left to right this time. Pitches it off to Kohler. Kohler, here's Sharps. Gets by Watson, defender swap here. Velasco with it now. She's going to try the three. Left it short off the outside of the iron. Here comes Watson in transition. Chella Watson gets around Kohler under the basket. Could not get it. Lost it out of her hand. Is wanting a foul called. The official not going to give it to her. So Bowling Green, a nice defensive stop there. Buffalo scoreless now for over the last 3 minutes. Bowling Green on a 5-0 run that at the time, during that time. Sharps down low, feeds Porter, trying to fight through a two-on-one. It's ripped away by Watson. Lopez down low, finds Lewis Williams. A nice sequence of stretch passes for Buffalo there. 18-13, just over 2 minutes into the second quarter here. One guarding one, El Husseini trying to guard Velasco. Now the basketball goes off into the hands of Sharps on the right wing. Here's Watson to defend. Down low, Porter trying to fight through a three-on-one situation this time.
And I like what they're trying to do, though. Get off-ball screens for Morgan, and then also trying to feed Erica as much as you can down low.
Sophie Zekin going to check back into the game. That's the fourth turnover of the game for Erica Porter. Bowling Green has nine. El Husseini slowly up the floor, and you can tell this Buffalo team really not trying to push the pace. They've got Bowling Green at this point where they want him. Ogden for three once again. Off the pass from Watson, couldn't connect on the bucket that time. Here comes Kohler up the floor, can't get inside once again, and that's what Buffalo has done really well. They've protected that inside. Bowling Green's had trouble getting any lower than the free throw line. Kohler on the outside, goes to feed Zekin. A foul going to be called in the middle there on Buffalo. It'll go on Hattie Ogden. So Bowling Green will inbound from the baseline here. That'll prompt Becky Burke to bring Kiara Johnson back in. Velasco gets it into Zekin. Right back into the hands of the junior from Centerville. Now here's Kohler from the top of the key. Gives off to Velasco once again. Going to take a chance. Now Kohler open on the outside for three. Left it shy. Watson able to get the basketball moving forward. Lopez stuffed by Hill. Now trying to get rid of the basketball and does. Watson on the outside has it once again. Working her way inside around two defenders. Chella Watson with the left hand. The rim says no. Velasco has it for Bowling Green. Again, the Falcons will go back to work, trying to find an avenue to get it inside. Kohler, Velasco, and Sharps all stationed between the top of the key and the right corner. Now Velasco will move out to the left side. Hill going inside, and a travel going to be called. And actually, they'll whistle that as a foul.
I like what Bowling Green's starting to do. They're starting to try to cut to the defense more on dribble drives and split the defense. Amy's doing a great job of that so far in creating open shots for guys in the corner.
And now we have a scoreless stretch going once again. Bowling Green for over the last 3 minutes. Buffalo for the last two. El Husseini the basketball here, looking down low. Lewis Williams trying to get through the defense, beats the two on one. The Bulls lead is back out to 7, 20-13 here. Just over 4 minutes gone by in the second quarter. Velasco has the ball on the outside for Bowling Green. Sharps cuts in front. Velasco still with it. Moves it to the left side. Here's Kohler. Now Sharps once again. Wanted the catch and shoot. Lopez there closely. Kohler gets the handoff pass. A foul going to be called. It'll go on Buffalo. It'll go against Lopez. And now here comes Emily Cecil into the game for the first time. The second sub we've seen for Bowling Green outside of Sophie Zekin. So for the first time tonight, Emily Cecil getting minutes for Bowling Green. Velasco gives to Sharps here. Cecil stationed in the left corner looking to find an avenue around El Husseini. Sharps off the glass. Not enough on it to get it over the rim. Zekin wasn't in position for an offensive rebound. Watson at the other end. Foul going to be called on Olivia Hill. And Chella Watson headed to the free throw line.
Yeah, Brandon, she's a 79.6% free throw shooter, so it'll be pretty important. The first free throws of the game.
Not the best free throw shooter on the team in terms of what Buffalo has to offer. Rena El Husseini sits just below 90%, but certainly even at that 80% or close to it mark that Watson sits at, not someone you want to send to the free throw line a whole lot.
Yeah, you don't want to get her going. Obviously, like we said before, 23.3 points a game. You don't want to get her starting to get in a rhythm.
Could not get the first. Does knock down the second. A 50% trip at the line. The first time we've seen free throws from either side tonight come about midway through this second quarter. Taya Ellis into the game for Bowling Green. Velasco the basketball. Sharps and Cecil go back and forth now. Morgan Sharps eyeing up Velasco. Velasco with the basketball trying to get around Watson. Defense doing a nice job at getting to the basketball, but we will get a foul once again.
It's been a majority of the offense tonight has been Amy cutting to the basket, cutting through the defense, I'm sorry, and creating stuff, either a foul or open shot.
And that's Chella Watson's second foul of the game. Just 4 points for Watson right now on 1 of 7 shooting. So not the night Buffalo would like to be having from their superstar. But they're in the lead by 8 nonetheless, 21-13. Halfway through the second quarter, Morgan Sharps trying to knock down a three there. Sharps has been 50% at the line prior to that one that she could not get. El Husseini slowing things down. Buffalo back on offense. Next whistle will mark the second quarter media timeout. Going inside, Velasco comes up with a block. Clean, nothing but basketball. And Fred Shamil fired up there. Buffalo will have the basketball, but not before we get to the media timeout. 4:41 left to go in the second quarter. We have reached the media timeout, another one of our timeouts brought to you by Juniper Brewing Company, located at 145 South Main Street in downtown Bowling Green, featuring coffee and craft beer, serving breakfast, lunch, and dinner. See the latest menu at juniperbrew.com. Buffalo leads Bowling Green 21-13 here from the Stroh Center, 4:41 to play in the first half. You're listening to Bowling Green Women's Basketball right here on 88.1 WBGU.
Hey everybody, Rachel Ray here. Nothing brings a bigger smile to my face than cooking up a big meal for the whole family and lots of friends. But there's not enough room at my table for the 17 million kids in our country who struggle with hunger. That's why the Feeding America nationwide network of food banks collects surplus food to give hope to hungry kids. But they can't do it without your help. Support Feeding America and your local food bank at feedingamerica.org.
A message from Feeding America and the Ad Council.
Sweet strawberry icing.
You're in Goodwill and just past that vintage denim jacket you spot. Miniature donut earrings. You lean in. Ah. That's the scent of shopping success. Because at Goodwill, every item you buy funds local job training and more. So bring home those donut earrings and bring home so much good to your community. Goodwill. Bring good home. Brought to you by Goodwill and the Ad Council.
You can be an essential part of the morning show's continued success on WBGU-FM. The Bowling Green Chamber of Commerce offers businesses and organizations an opportunity to be an underwriter. Under the umbrella of the Chamber, you'll receive your mentions each month during either news and sports programming or feature segments. It's an affordable opportunity to be part of something unique in Wood County.
Imagine being fired because of who you love. Imagine being denied medical treatment because of who you marry. Imagine being evicted because of who you are. Millions of Americans don't have to imagine this. They have to live it. Because in 31 states, it's legal to discriminate against LGBT people. Get the facts at beyondido.org. Brought to you by the Gill Foundation and the Ad Council.
Back here from the Stroh Center once again, another presentation of Bowling Green Women's Basketball here, brought to you by the Falcon Media Sports Network. Brandelow Camworth back with you here as Buffalo has the basketball in an 8-point lead. Kirsten Lewis-Williams inside, but an offensive foul called. Velasco sets the feet and draws the charge for Bowling Green. Sophie Zekin gives in to Velasco here as the Falcons look to come back up the floor scoreless for the last 5 minutes. Bowling Green needs a bucket here. A low-scoring first half, and we will get a whistle. And somebody lost something. Looks like a piece of plastic may have made its way onto the floor. So we will reset here, 23 seconds on the shot clock, 4:29 left to play in the half. Velasco looking in, gets the basketball to Emily Cecil. Velasco now leading the floor as we have become so accustomed to for Bowling Green. Porter trying to get open on the inside, Cecil back out to Velasco. Foul going to be called there on Lopez. And now Buffalo's foul total starting to climb a little bit here. The second foul on Lopez there. So Davis, Watson, and Lopez all have two. For Bowling Green, Olivia Hill, the only player with two fouls. And Bowling Green just three fouls as a team.
Like you said in the pregame show, Brandon, Erica is having a tough time down low. I mean, this Buffalo team's giving Erica all she can handle down low, especially with front side help and backside help.
So Amy Velasco to the free throw line here was 12 of 12 across her two games last week in which Bowling Green won. She'll keep that momentum rolling here, makes the first at the line this time for Bowling Green. Knocks down Bowles, so Amy Velasco stays hot at the free throw line. But shockingly enough, that's Amy's first pair of points tonight. Kirsten Lewis-Williams back on offense for Buffalo. We will get a whistle. Foul going to be called this time on Cecil. And Bowling Green, again, you know, they have checked in all or three out of their four reserves on the bench, that being Ellis, Cecil, and Zekin. Not a whole lot of production in terms of the bench right now for Bowling Green. None of the three have scored, and that's been something that Bowling Green has had to deal with over the last few weeks. Lewis-Williams going inside. Cecil draws the charge. Another offensive foul called on Kirsten Lewis-Williams. And now she has two personal fouls. So Velasco up the floor once again. A two-score game, 21-15, 3:54 left to play in the first half. Zekin has the basketball at the left elbow. Porter trying to find her way down low as well. Trying to create some separation. Zekin back to Velasco. Velasco working inside from the top of the key. Kicks out. Cecil for three on its way. And that one was clean through the hoop from Emily Cecil. Rena El Husseini moves it down low through the hands of Ogden out of bounds. Just like that, the Stroh Center crowd coming alive here as their team gets a little bit of momentum. A bucket and a stop at the other end. So Velasco forward once again. It's a three-point game, 21-18. Zekin feet on that three-point line. Looking over the top, down low, got it to Porter. Lewis-Williams poked it away and launched into the front row. Trying to save the basketball, but last touched by Lewis-Williams out of bounds. Bowling Green will keep it. Sat right in the lap of one of the Bowling Green faithful there, trying to do all she could to keep that basketball alive. So Bowling Green inbounds, starts with Velasco. Now Sharps has the basketball. Five on the shot clock. Velasco straight away takes the three. That one off the mark well to the left side. But Velasco had to get something there as time was winding down on the shot clock. Under 3 minutes to play in the first half. El Husseini moves it down low. Kiara Johnson trying to get through. Erica Porter and does. Buffalo, one of their last five from the floor. Here comes Porter. Now Cecil on the outside, fresh off a three. Nearly got the basketball there once again, but fumbled it a little bit. Sharps had to come over and provide some help after she initially made the pass. Porter going inside, beats Johnson, and there's a start for Erica Porter at the offensive end.
That's what we see. That's the first time in a while she hasn't been double teamed, so that was great to see.
El Husseini, the basketball here. Off to Johnson, back out. Ogden open for three, lets it go. A foul going to be called. It's going to go on Sophie Zekin. El Husseini went to the ground there. Sito Hines into the game. And to the free throw line this time goes Rena El Husseini. El Husseini able to get the first, and we mentioned free throw shooting for Buffalo, and El Husseini, one of the best in the Mid-American Conference in terms of what she's able to do at the free throw line, averaging nearly 90% at the charity stripe this year. Knocks down both without hesitation, and certainly if you're head coach Becky Burke, you love to have a player like that in Rena El Husseini, who you know when she goes to the free throw line, more often than not, the ball's going to find its way through. Amy Velasco, the basketball here for Bowling Green. 25-20, Buffalo does lead. Still a low-scoring first half. Cecil, the basketball here, making her way inside. Moves it back out. Sharps on the left wing. Now looking back off to Velasco. Little pump fake there. Down low, finds Porter once again. Gets through the two-on-one this time. Erica Porter coming around late in half one for Bowling Green. We go from half one to number one. El Husseini the basketball once again. Ogden and El Husseini, a back and forth. Kick out into the corner. Hines looking for three. And would it not be a Buffalo first half if Hines didn't knock down that three? The three ball continues to fall for the Bulls. 5 of 9 from behind the arc. Velasco moves it forward for Bowling Green once again. Zekin inside the perimeter. Back off to Velasco. Little handoff pass that time. Knocked away by Hines. Here comes Cecil through the lane. Back out into the corner. There's Zekin off to Velasco. Under a minute left in the first half. Velasco looking. Floater finds its way through. Touches the nylon on its way down. It's still a one-score game. 27-24. El Husseini forward with the basketball. 40 seconds on the clock. Buffalo content to continue to take time off this one. El Husseini, floater from the right elbow. Left it short. Gets after it. Got her own rebound on the other side of the floor. Impressive hustle there from Rena El Husseini. Still a 10-second difference between the game and shot clock. As El Husseini has the basketball once again, approaching the perimeter, working out to the right side, finds Ogden. Porter gets in her face. Ogden, a defender swap here, gets over the top of Zekin and gets the bucket. Here comes Bowling Green. It's a five-point game once again, less than 10 on the clock. 29-24, Buffalo leads. El Husseini goes down off a nice move by Velasco, but Johnson able to get the block, and Buffalo will send a full court heave the other way as the first half comes to a close. It's the Bulls on top of the Falcons right now by 5, 29-24. You're listening to Bowling Green Women's Basketball right here on 88.1 WBGU.
To protect her home and family in a disaster, Karen was willing to wade through water, mud, and insurance paperwork.
Yeah, I can do this.
You go, Karen! By simply understanding and updating what her insurance covers and doesn't cover now, she'll be better prepared no matter when disaster strikes. Learn other simple ways to protect your home and family before a natural disaster at ready.gov. That's ready.gov. A message from FEMA and the Ad Council.
I'm probably okay to have one more drink before I drive home. I'm probably okay. I open the window to stay alert.
Probably okay. I just popped some gum in my mouth.
Step out of the car, please.
I probably made a mistake.
Probably okay isn't okay when it comes to drinking and driving. If you see a warning sign, stop and call a cab, a car, or a friend. Buzzed driving is drunk driving. A message brought to you by NHTSA and the Ad Council.
Falcons battle against Michigan Tech in the regular season home finale. Join FMSN's Ben Korak and Nick Bowers alongside special guests Joe Borenstein and John Bowers on the call at 6:45 for pregame and 7 p.m. for puck drop. Catch the big game on 88.1 FM WBGU.
So I'm a cat, and I just moved in with this new human, and she's got this little toy she's always playing with all day long. Tap, 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 bloop, bloop. She can't put it down. There it is. Oh, and get this. She even talks to it. Last week, she asked it for Chinese. And guess what? Egg rolls showed up. Like magic. Humans have cool toys.
A person is the best thing to happen to a shelter pet. Be that person. Adopt. Brought to you by the Ad Council and the ShelterPetProject.org.
This is you over 30 years ago.
Are we there yet? Are we there yet?
And this is your mom now.
Are we there yet? Are we there yet?
Roles change without us noticing. That's why AARP gives you the information to provide even better care for your loved one. Visit aarp.org/caregiving. Brought to you by AARP and the Ad Council.
The Morning Show on WBGU-FM is brought to you by the Bowling Green Chamber of Commerce. For more information, contact The Morning Show at themorningshow@bgchamber.net. Send them any program suggestions or information you might have. They are always looking for show ideas and guests. To have your birthday or anniversary announced, email or call the Bowling Green Chamber of Commerce at 419-353-7945.
I'm a 40-year-old man that walked in there to get his high school diploma. It was very hard for me, but Miss Araceli, she gave me direction.
At age 47, Marco finished his high school diploma.
50% of getting your high school diploma is walking through those doors. The other 50% is doing the work.
No one gets a diploma alone. If you're thinking of finishing your high school diploma, you have help. Find free adult education classes near you at finishyourdiploma.org. That's finishyourdiploma.org. Brought to you by the Dollar General Literacy Foundation and the Ad Council.
A ranger station.
I'd like to report a bear hug.
Okay.
I put out my campfire and Smokey Bear hugged me.
So you drowned the fire, you stirred it, drowned it again, and felt that it was cold?
Uh-huh.
Yep, he's just letting you know you did good.
Bear hug from Smokey Bear. Status update.
I'm gonna let you go now. There are many ways to start a fire, but one sure way to put it out. Learn how you can do your part at SmokeyBear.com.
Sponsored by the U.S. Forest Service, Ad Council, and your state forester.
Long ago, you wouldn't think of galloping on a horse while doing calligraphy. And you wouldn't have attempted to ride your bike while typing a letter. Yet you think you can safely operate a multi-ton vehicle while texting? Behind the wheel is no place to multitask. If you want to BRB, drive now and text later. Lives depend on it.
Visit StopTextStopWrecks.org, a message brought to you by the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration, Project Yellow Light, Noise, and the Ad Council.
The Western Scrub Jay. I was taking my science class on a virtual reality bird watching expedition. All of a sudden, Charlie Kane shouts, "Arr! Arr!" He had spotted the elusive black swift, a bird rarely seen in the wild. For a brief moment, Charlie had not the eyes of a 9-year-old boy. He had the eyes of an eagle.
Teachers just have better work stories. Find out how creative teaching can be at teachdfw.org. Brought to you by Teach and the Ad Council.
I'm Surgeon General Jerome Adams. If you've recovered from COVID-19 confirmed by a positive test, you're in a special position to help us fight the virus. Your plasma has antibodies that may help others fight COVID. So please donate plasma now. You can literally help save lives. There are locations across the country that have safe ways for you to donate. Find a site to donate your plasma at coronavirus.gov.
Produced by the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services at taxpayer expense.
Back here from the Stroll Center, another Wednesday night Mid-American Conference basketball contest between the Buffalo Bulls and the Bowling Green Falcons tonight. Brandon Lowe, Cam Orth back with you here on behalf of Bowling Green Falcon Media, BG Falcon Media, the Falcon Media Sports Network. At the break, Buffalo leads by 5, 29-24. And Cam, when you look at some of the stats, you would think this one may be a little bit more spread out than it is, but Bowling Green, they've been able to hang around in this one and keep it to a close game as we get ready to go from first to second half.
Yeah, started off early with a bunch of turnovers from BG, but they settled in a little bit. And then it kind of flipped. You started to feel the momentum switch a little bit. They were down 8-16 in the first quarter. You're like, okay, could get out of hand. But then Buffalo starts to turn over. BG makes a few good stops. Get some good minutes out of Emily Cecil. And Amy Velasco really started to attack the paint and dish the ball and draw a bunch of double teams and get some open shots for some people.
Late in the first half, Erica Porter really got going as well. We only saw a pair of buckets from her towards the end of the half. Had one early on, but certainly they looked to her a lot at the beginning stages of the game. Couldn't get it to her. Late in the second half, they were able to find her. She was able to get a little bit more aggressive while keeping it clean, and that helped Bowling Green out a little bit as the first half went along.
Yeah, it's tough because Buffalo's playing Erica really well. They're playing front side defense on her, making her throw it over top, but then they also have a lot of back. They've been doing a great job of backside help. So it's really hard to get her the ball, and obviously they were able to do it towards the end of the first half, which obviously led to some points. But if they can keep finding a way to get her the ball, she's going to be a big help in the second half.
So when we take a look at the individual stats for Buffalo, Rena El Husseini leads with 8 points. She hit two big threes right away to start the game. 2 of 2 from behind the three-point line. She adds another pair at the free throw line. That's how she's gotten to her 8, but also leads the team tonight in rebounds and assists. 5 rebounds, 4 assists. She's got 2 steals as well. So Rena El Husseini has stepped up tonight for the Bulls. On down the line, Hattie Ogden has 5 points off the bench. 3 different players have 4, and then the Bulls have a duo with 2 points apiece in Kiara Johnson and Sito Hines. On the other side for Bowling Green, Morgan Sharps leads the way, 8 points. A slow start for Sharps, kind of came around later in the first half as well. And then beyond that, Erica Porter has 6 points. Amy Velasco has 4, and Paige Kohler and Emily Cecil have both connected on a three-point try as well. And for Bowling Green, that three-point defense is something that's going to have to change. They've had to deal with it over the last couple of games. I mentioned in the first half, Akron shot 12 of 25 against Bowling Green last Wednesday. Northern Illinois started 5 of 7 from three-point land on Saturday, and now here at the half, Buffalo shooting 4 of 8, 50%, which when you look at it, Bowling Green, yeah, they've made 4 threes too, but Buffalo's efficiency is what's got them out in front by just a couple of points.
Exactly like you said, efficiency. Early on, it was all Buffalo. Turnovers on the offensive end for BG. Buffalo going down. Obviously, Chella, first three of the game, went down. Hasn't made a lot of sense, but early on, her three, and then obviously you see the El Husseini's ability to get it done in every facet of the game, whether it be rebounds, assists, or playing lockdown defense. I mean, she's done it all tonight for Buffalo.
So when we look at the team stats, Buffalo won the first quarter. Bowling Green actually did outscore Buffalo 14-13 in that second quarter. Bowling Green, surprisingly, based on the numbers we've seen, has more points off of turnovers than Buffalo does. 8-6 in that column favors Bowling Green. The paint points are even. Buffalo does have 5 more second chance points than Bowling Green, and the bench outscoring that of the Falcons as well. 19 minutes and 17 seconds spent in the lead for Buffalo, and that was really, you know, as soon as they scored 43 seconds into the game, they have led ever since. So we'll see if Bowling Green can sort of climb their way into that lead dog position and lead for some time here in the second half. This has been the Halftime Update brought to you by The Zig Zone, Bowling Green's sports show, 4 o'clock on Sundays on WBGU 88.1. You can listen to it Sundays at 4 o'clock, The Zig Zone, an entire roundtable about nothing but Bowling Green athletics. So make sure you check out The Zig Zone. That just started a couple of weeks ago, looking to get that going, moving forward the rest of this year and into the next academic year as well. So make sure you check out Zig Zone. 4 o'clock, 88.1 WBG, right here where you're listening to us on Sundays at 4 p.m. Again, this has been the Halftime Update. We will step aside. Buffalo leads Bowling Green 29-24. You're listening to Bowling Green Women's Basketball right here on 88.1 WBGU.
Jill, why don't you tell the class what you did this weekend?
Well, my dad and I went in search of some magical minnows and found a zillion of them in the stream from our lookout rock. Then my sister and I escaped from an evil slug king and went back to my super twig fort for safety. Then we told stories till it got dark, and the Big Dipper led us all the way home. Wow.
Where were you, Jill?
We went to the forest. It's not that far away.
Ask your parents to take you and your friends to the forest this week. It's closer than you think. Check out discovertheforest.org. Brought to you by the U.S. Forest Service and the Ad Council.
I'm a wife,
a sister,
and a grandfather.
I'm an office clerk.
I'm a research analyst,
dance fitness instructor,
actor.
I'm a copywriter.
I'm a veteran.
I have lupus,
cerebral palsy.
I'm blind.
And I'm working in a job I love.
I love.
Because I was given a chance.
To contribute my skills and talents.
To show that my disability
is only one part of who I am.
Who I am.
Who I am.
At work, it's what people can do that matters.
For more information, visit whatcanyoudocampaign.org.
Complement your WBGU radio experience with additional content available online. Subscribe to our social media feeds on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter to receive information about special events, promotional activities, and the program schedule. Stay connected with WBGU wherever you go and return to Radio Freedom. 88.1 FM WBGU Bowling Green, Ohio.
Jason and Greg Spurgeon are a pair of brothers on the BGSU men's basketball team who both grew up in Toowoomba, Australia. They both played high school basketball at Toowoomba Grammar School, where the older brother, Jason, was captain of the team twice, and younger brother, Greg, captained once in 2020. Jason, prior to transferring to BGSU, was the leading blocker for Southern Utah University and the second best blocker in the Western Athletic Conference. Greg appeared in 6 games for Westminster Griffins and totaled 5 points, 4 rebounds, and a steal. This has been 60 Seconds in Falcon Athletics on 88.1 FM WBGU, Northwest Ohio's community radio station.
Eating, working, living pain-free. These are a few of the things many of us take for granted. But for many adults with disabilities who are elderly or have serious medical issues, dental care is simply unaffordable. Dental Lifeline Network is looking for dentists who can change this. DLN is asking dentists and their teams to volunteer to just see one of the many patients in need. You can literally change a life. Visit willyouseeone.org to help change one life in your community today.
My name is Jim. I'm a veteran, and I lost both legs in Vietnam. My victory was proving that a disability is not a limitation.
I'm Julius. I'm a veteran. My victory was going from homeless to home.
At DAV, we're on a mission, helping veterans of all generations get the benefits they've earned.
I'm Cece. My victory was finishing my education.
When America's veterans win, we all win. Help us support more victories for veterans. Go to DAV.org.
The journey of 1,000 miles begins with the first step. At Children International, we know that the journey to end poverty for good begins first with a child. It starts with their first checkup, lesson, opportunity, job. That journey takes commitment from people like you and me to end poverty for good. Learn more at children.org.
We depend on our drinking water supply daily, but where does that water come from? Your water provider encourages you to get to know your local water source so together we can protect and preserve it. The investments we make as a community to protect our water source now ensure we have a sustainable drinking water supply for the future. Visit drinktap.org to learn more. This message is brought to you by the American Water Works Association and your local water provider.
Hey, I'm Tyler Kavlitz, and you are listening to 88.1 FM WBGU Bowling Green, home of the Falcon Media Sports Network.
Back here at the Stroh Center Wednesday night, in action here between Buffalo and Bowling Green as these two Wibbitz basketball teams look to one up the other in terms of the Mid-American Conference standings with only 3 games to go after tonight before we head to Rocket Mortgage Fieldhouse in Cleveland on March 13 when the Mid-American Conference tournament will get underway. Buffalo the basketball here to start the second half. Alexis Davis into Kirsten Lewis-Williams. The Bulls have the ball to start the half. First offensive possession here. Watson outside, steps inside. Good defense from Kohler. Lewis-Williams had it knocked away by Velasco. Davis is able to corral it. El Husseini from the corner. Too long on the three-point try, but an offensive rebound for the Bulls. Here's Alexis Davis working the perimeter back to Chella Watson. An extra pass there in the middle from Lewis-Williams. El Husseini going to get a chance to go with that corner three once again. Isn't going to miss both, and blew a kiss to the student section afterwards and claps as well on her way back down the floor. Rena El Husseini trying to keep up the intensity that she had back in the first half. The first player into double figures. She's got 11 tonight, 3 of 4 from behind the three-point line. 32-24, Buffalo leads by 8, just under a minute played here in the third quarter. Paige Kohler looking to explode to the inside, couldn't there. Lewis Williams, the tight defense. Now it's Sharps inside, offensive foul as Alexis Davis draws the charge. Bowling Green kept it clean back in the first half. Just 5 fouls in the first 20 minutes for the Falcons. Their first of the second half comes 1-0-1 into play. So here comes Buffalo out of the backcourt. The tandem of Davis and El Husseini forward once again. Davis on the right side this time. Back around. It works its way to Lewis Williams. Watson trying to get open on the inside. The one thing that you could say that Bowling Green has done, they have neutralized Chella Watson to an extent. Davis over the top, and Alexis Davis, a nice little kiss there off the rim, gets it to fall. So here's the last go for Bowling Green. Buffalo now up 10, their first double-digit lead of the game. Down low to Porter, a foul going to be called. It'll go against Kiara Johnson, and that is Johnson's first foul of the game.
A great job of Morgan Sharps realizing that Erica Porter was one-on-one downside in the paint, so getting her to the rock and be able to draw a foul.
So Velasco will head to the baseline looking for an inbound pass here for Bowling Green. They do like to go to Porter when they can get it to her, but Porter covered up that time. They'll go to Kohler instead. On the outside, pitch pass to Sharps. Here comes Velasco, middle of the lane, back out. Kohler thought about a three. Now a little behind-the-back move there. El Husseini went down away from the basketball, quickly gets back to her feet. Here comes Kohler on Lewis Williams, bottled up, ripped away, and we are going to get a jump ball call. Possession arrow does stay with Bowling Green. Mop duty real quick where that tandem went to the floor. The officials looking up at the shot clock. Talking things over. 3 seconds left on the shot clock here. Velasco into Porter, over the top, back to Velasco. Blocked there, down low, Alexis Davis knocks it away. Buffalo's defense has not quit one possession down the floor. They have made it difficult for Bowling Green all night, and that's why you see such a low-scoring effort from Bowling Green right now. And now the officials going to have another conversation again. Both teams will go to their benches. Becky Burke not pleased by the delay of game, if you will. So both teams going to get a chance to talk things over. For Bowling Green, they have not scored yet this half. A minute and 56 seconds into this one. The officials will go over to the monitor and take a look. Both assistant coaches getting the explanation. And it was a quick look. Clearly did not favor the Bowling Green side, as Fred Jamil not as content with the response as Coach Burke. Buffalo will have the basketball as they come up the floor here. Their 10-point lead, their largest of the game. Lewis Williams off to Watson. Watson made her first three, has not made one since. Inside there, tried to go over the top with a floater, couldn't connect on it. Velasco right to left, finds Kohler. Hill down low, has an opening, but a foul going to be called under the basket. This one going to go against Alexis Davis, and that's Davis's third. And Cam, that was one of the things you mentioned back in the first half. If Bowling Green could get Davis into some foul trouble, that could mean good things for Bowling Green. Three fouls now here, less than 2.5 minutes into the third quarter. Paige Kohler, the basketball here, as Bowling Green has the possession. Off to Velasco, has some space open up, down low, Porter. Velasco did a nice job to draw in the defense there and it left Erica Porter open underneath to connect on the bucket. Erna El Husseini, 34-36, her squad leads. Watson off to El Husseini in the right corner this time. Steps away from Hill. Back out Watson for three. That one on a line, but off to the left. Velasco forward. Here comes Sharps. Catch and shoot. That one looks good, but it comes up short. El Husseini, another rebound. Her sixth of the game. Wanted to go off to Watson. Kohler was lurking in the area. Lewis Williams over the top there with the shot. Little fadeaway there, left it too long, died off the back iron into the hands of the Falcons. Velasco off the Sharps, drew over the double team. Lewis Williams quick to drop back over and guard Velasco. Here comes Kohler. Basketball in hand, off to Velasco once again. Velasco and Kohler, game of back and forth now. Trying to get it down low to Porter, snags it off the fingertips of Johnson and one for Erica Porter.
That's what exactly what they need to do. They found a matchup, even though last time Morgan got it to her when she was one-on-one in the paint. This time she got it to her when there was a defender in front and behind Erica Porter, but still got it to her, and then Erica, obviously, with the and-one finish is huge.
And Erica Porter, on the season, just a 54% free throw shooter, but when we were back in the first month of Mid-American Conference play, that number was down around 48%. So a 6% increase for Erica Porter, who is the highest volume free throw shooter on the team for Bowling Green. Could not get the free throw this time. But regardless, Bowling Green has cut it back to a 6-point game, 34-28, Buffalo leads. El Husseini off to Watson. Watson still standing in that BG logo at center court. Now moving forward, approaching the perimeter, Hill on defense. Watson left the basketball off for Lewis Williams. Kohler nearly able to snag it away. Instead, Buffalo keeps it. Watson looks at it once again from the right elbow. Porter comes up with a rebound, and Chella Watson ice cold right now. 1 of 10 from the floor tonight. Velasco off to Sharps. Here comes Morgan Sharps looking inside. Little pull up there. It was in and out, halfway down, and it lipped back out.
They need to keep her cold, honestly. Watson, she can't. They can't let her start to get it going because that won't be good. Obviously, 23 points a game, not playing quite to what she's typically played to. So if they can keep her locked tight, then this should be good.
El Husseini winding time off the clock, approaching halfway here in the third quarter. Watson the basketball now gets a screen from Davis, steps back off the dummy screen and takes the three. Foul going to be called down low. If this is on Alexis Davis, it'll be her fourth, and it is. The fourth foul on Alexis Davis, so just one more left. Burke will have to go to the bench. Here comes Kiara Johnson.
6 rebounds game for Davis. It's going to be a huge loss if they can keep her out of the game.
And Davis has done a nice job as a freshman throughout this season, but really tonight trying to keep Erica Porter in check. Bowling Green has been able to go to Porter more in this Porter-Johnson matchup that Erica Porter finds herself in right now. Here's Kohler on the outside, guarded by Lewis Williams. Looking down low, they go right to Porter, and they're going to attack that now is Bowling Green.
Double team, doesn't matter. Her size, can't stop her.
Erica Porter up to 12 on the night. She leads the game with 12 points. 34-30, Buffalo leads, but Bowling Green continuing to chip away. Buffalo scoreless for the last 3.5 minutes. El Husseini the basketball here, guarded by Velasco at the top of the key. Lewis Williams not expecting the pass, but able to bring it in. Inside around Porter, Lewis Williams, difficult bucket there. And a timeout going to be called by Buffalo. And another one of our timeouts brought to you by Juniper Brewing Company, located at 145 South Main Street in downtown Bowling Green, featuring coffee and craft beer, serving breakfast, lunch, and dinner. See the latest menu at juniperbrew.com. The Buffalo Bulls leading the Bowling Green Falcons in this one, 36-30, 4:36 left to go in the third. You're listening to Bowling Green Women's Basketball right here on 88.1 WBGU.
Every year, millions of Americans use opioids to manage pain. And reliance on opioids has led to the worst drug crisis in American history. That's why the CDC recommends safer alternatives
like physical therapy to manage pain. Physical therapists treat pain through movement, hands-on care, and patient education. No warning labels required. When it comes to your health, you have a choice. Choose physical therapy. Visit moveforwardpt.com to find a physical therapist in your area.
Hi, everybody. I'm Jack Hanna. Since I was a boy, I've been fascinated with animals, especially their tireless work ethic. Just look at birds who gather supplies to build nests, or penguins who travel up to 500 miles to secure food for their families. This work ethic is shared by our best friends, canines who perform life-saving work every day. Dogs comfort returning veterans. They work with diabetics, alerting them when there's a change in their blood chemistry. Working dogs are valuable in many ways. So please join me, an American Humane, in supporting our heroic working dogs. Go to AmericanHumane.org to learn more.
Crooked teeth may embarrass kids whose families can't afford braces. And trying to fix their teeth themselves can make things worse. Luckily, there's Donated Orthodontic Services, a program from the American Association of Orthodontists. For children and teens who qualify and are matched with a volunteer orthodontist, treatment can be life-changing and help them smile with confidence. Learn more at aaoinfo.org.
A few years ago, Steve Faircow's lungs were failing.
I don't think I had more than a couple weeks to live.
That's when Steve received a lung transplant made possible by an organ donor. Now Steve can do things he never imagined, like climbing 94 floors to the top of a skyscraper.
I never knew that breathing could feel this good. It's an incredible gift.
What could you make possible as an organ, eye, and tissue donor? Leave behind the gift of life. Go to organdonor.gov, U.S. Department of Health and Human Services, Health Resources and Services Administration.
Back here from the Stroh Center once again. Things tightening back up here around the mid-stages of the third quarter. Brandon Lowe, Cam Orth back with you here on behalf of Falcon Media Sports Network and BG Falcon Media, bringing you an entire season of Bowling Green women's basketball just a week and a half away, 2 weeks away exactly from the start of the Mid-American Conference Tournament, but a week and a half away from the end of the regular season. Bowling Green going to have the basketball here after the bucket from Kirsten Lewis-Williams before we went to break, and just like that, here come the Falcons up the floor. Hill and Velasco out of the backcourt, side by side come the tandem. Paige Kohler with it now on the left wing, moves it to Morgan Sharps further on the left side. Back to the freshman in Kohler. Here's Velasco once again. Tight defense there from Watson. Sharps has the basketball now. Here comes Kohler. Finds Velasco trying to open things up for Porter down low. Instead, Bowling Green keeps it on the outside. Here goes Kohler to the inside. Johnson able to come up with a stop. Kohler able to get the basketball back. Two on the clock. Down to one. Kohler lets it go, but it did not leave her hands fast enough. And are they going to count that bucket? They are going to count it. And I believe they're going to go back and look at that one at the next stoppage. That'll be how they play that one out. But I do not think Kohler got it off in time. Watson goes inside that time, leaves it off the mark once again, trying to get around Porter. Sharps at the offensive end. She's going to take that look all day, but too long it carries off the rim. Ogden able to bring in the board. So an interesting sequence there as Burke wanted them to rule that no basket right away. They continued play, almost gave up a three in transition because they were so off key. Here comes Watson back on offense for Buffalo, gets around Hill this time, but again, Watson just cannot find the bottom of the cup. One for 13, here's Sharps again. That one off the mark as well. Porter going after the rebound. Here's an offensive board for Bowling Green. Sharp's going to pull up this time, a long two from the baseline, and that ball loose on the floor. Porter gets another one. And right now, Kiara Johnson not happy, chirping in the ear of Erica Porter as she ended up on her can down low. Velasco off the Hill. Here's Sharps back to Porter down low. Draws the double team, trying to fight through contact. Erica Porter off the glass. How about it? Number 32.
She's already got a double-double, Brandon. It's only the end of the third.
14 points, 10 rebounds. Have yourself a night, Erica Porter. And like you said, Cam, still early. Inside El Husseini tries to drive. Could not get to the basket. Here's Sharps going inside. Moves it to Hill. Hill looking after the two. Trying to get a little mid-range jumper action going there with 2:15 left, but could not find the basket. 36-34 as it stands on the scoreboard now. Still pretty convinced that the officials will go back and look at that bucket by Kohler when that was close to a shot clock violation. Watson has the basketball here for Buffalo, but Bowling Green has the momentum. Buffalo scoreless once again for the last 2.5 minutes. Kiara Johnson moves it. Chella Watson looking inside. Back to Johnson down low, trying to get through Porter, and a foul going to be called. It will go on Erica Porter. And that just Porter's second foul for a Bowling Green team that has only committed 7 all night. It has been a relatively clean game for Bowling Green. And now we will get a timeout here, and Fred Shamil comes across half court asking about something. And if the officials are going to go to the monitor and look at that bucket from Kohler, this will be the time that they do it. So we'll find out in just a couple of moments. But for right now, Buffalo down to a 2-point lead, 36-34 over Bowling Green, 1:48 left to go in the third. You're listening to Bowling Green Women's Basketball right here on 88.1 WBGU.
Matt always knew he wanted to be a doctor. That's why he makes the most of every day. To study before breakfast, to work hard, to do whatever was necessary to achieve his goal. He found an answer in the military. If you have a passion, a vision for your future in any field, todaysmilitary.com can be your path to a fulfilling career. You have a calling, we have an answer. Find your way at todaysmilitary.com.
You have the right to know. The right to know about culture. The right to know about the economy. The right to know about technology and to know about sports. You have the right to know about education and politics and the weather. You have the right to know what's happening abroad and in your backyard. But above all else, you have the right to know that this right is under attack and we must work to protect it. Because in order to be free, we must be informed. Understand the threats. ProtectPressFreedom.org.
People join Walk MS to raise awareness and funds that change the world for everyone affected by multiple sclerosis. Walk MS brings communities together, creating teams with friends, loved ones, and coworkers to rally around those we care about and end MS forever. Together, we can change the world for people with MS. Register today at walkms.org.
Since the moment you were born, I've made 1,000 wishes. Wishes for your future in a world that's changing fast. Do play and laugh. Do win and lose. Do it all with confidence, kindness, and strength. And always do your best to remember that no matter what you do in this life, what matters to me is that you keep doing. Inspire kids to do at 4-H.org.
Dad, guess what?
What?
You are going to be a grandfather.
That's great. Not too long ago, moments like this with my daughter would have been a challenge. It was a long road for me to find myself again after Vietnam. It was my neighbor Jim, another Vietnam veteran, who finally convinced me that I could still connect with my family and find that fulfilling life I'd lost. And I went for help down at the VA. If I can take that first step after almost 50 years, I know other veterans can too. Visit maketheconnection.net to find out more.
Back here at the Stroh Center, courtside, Bill Frack Court, and they did review that bucket by Kohler as the shot clock expired a couple of minutes ago now. We've had a lot of plays since then, and they did rule it no basket. So Kohler did not get the bucket off in time, coming out of the break 36-32, and Kiara Johnson made her first of two free throws at the line, knocks down the second as well, and it's a 6-point lead for Buffalo. But Bowling Green has definitely started to upswing here as we get through the third quarter.
Find a way to get Eric Porter the ball, which is, I think, the biggest thing possible. And then, obviously, just like that.
Down low, guess who? Erica Porter, once again, just as you were talking about her, Cam, adds her 15 and 16th points of the night.
8 for 8 from the field right now, 100%.
38-34. Had a 10 of 11 performance here at the Stroh Center earlier this year. One of the highest field goal shooting performances in Bowling Green history. There's Kirsten Lewis-Williams at the offensive end, knocking it down for Buffalo. Velasco bringing the ball forward, a 6-point game, 1:05 left to play in the third. We knew it was going to be a good one coming in that meant a lot to these two teams. They're proving that every single minute that comes off the clock. Kohler the basketball here, down low, Porter trying to get behind Johnson. Here's Velasco, draws the double team, blocked by Johnson, Velasco trying to keep the basketball, but instead last touch by the junior out of bounds. So Buffalo will take over.
Amy's struggling a little bit tonight. 1 for 9 from the field, 4 points. Not quite the game she had last game, but still another quarter to turn it up.
So here is Watson bringing the offense forward for Buffalo, trying to get around Hill, and Chella Watson finally snaps out of the funk. 1 for 13 prior to that basket. Just 6 points tonight for, in my opinion, right now, the hands-down favorite for the Mid-American Conference Player of the Year Award. 3.5 seconds separating shot clock from game clock here. Velasco dishes it off to Sharps. Back to Amy Velasco. Velasco to Sharps. They continue to play catch. Now looking back to Velasco. Kohler was bunched in tight. Velasco through the middle. Lets the floater go. Got it off as the horn expired. Didn't fall. Third quarter comes to a close. Buffalo gets back-to-back buckets to end the third quarter, and it's an 8-point lead in favor of the Bulls. 42-34. We've got fourth quarter basketball coming up next. You're listening to Bowling Green Women's Basketball right here on 88.1 WBGU.
When someone hears the words, "you have cancer," it's one of the darkest moments in their life. Light the Night brings light to the darkness of cancer by uniting survivors, patients, and supporters in the cause to end cancer. We form a community of hope, raising funds in support of the Leukemia and Lymphoma Society. The discoveries made by LLS-supported research have led to breakthrough treatments for many cancers and other serious diseases. When we walk, cancer runs. Join the movement to end cancer today. Visit us at lightthenight.org.
Sweet strawberry icing.
You're in Goodwill and just past that vintage denim jacket, you spot miniature donut earrings. You lean in. Ah, that's the scent of shopping success. Because at Goodwill, every item you buy funds local job training and more. So bring home those donut earrings and bring home so much good to your community. Goodwill, bring good home. Brought to you by Goodwill and the Ad Council.
Standing up for what's right. Helping out when things go wrong. Seeking the truth and speaking our minds. Not just making records, but breaking them. Leading the way behind the camera, beyond the runway, and on the silver screen. Not just making our mark, but making a difference. Now that's a job for a Girl Scout. Girl Scouts, preparing girls for a lifetime of leadership.
Most of us like to be out in the sun. That's why sunscreen and other safety measures are key to protecting your skin from aging and cancer. The FDA recommends using a sunscreen with an SPF of 15 or higher. Also, look for broad spectrum on the label. That means both harmful ultraviolet A and B rays are blocked. Remember, SPF plus broad spectrum equal healthy fun in the sun. Visit www.fda.gov/sunscreen for more information. A message from the U.S. Food and Drug Administration.
Back here from the Stroh Center as we head into the fourth quarter. Bowling Green still has the ladder to climb in front of them. 42-34, the Buffalo Bulls leading the Bowling Green Falcons right now. Buffalo going to have the basketball to start the fourth quarter, and it's been a game where Bowling Green has gotten close, but they have never been able to surpass Buffalo and find themselves in the lead.
Buffalo's doing a good job of answering, just like you said, doing a good job of answering when they get the ball down to Erica Porter, scoring and just coming back down and scoring points every time.
Porter, 16 points, 11 rebounds right now in double-double territory, 8 of 8 from the field. Rena El-Husseini leads the scoring for Buffalo with 11 points. She starts the quarter off with the basketball. Watson down low the feed, and Kirsten Lewis-Williams, who has had herself a night as well, into double figures there on the made basket. So here's Bowling Green, back on offense, down 10. Needing points, got to find them somehow. Sharps working the perimeter. Hill on the outside, down low, they'll feed Porter, and a foul going to be called. A hard foul there. Kiara Johnson going to be hit with the foul call, and Erica Porter going to get back to her feet here. And Bowling Green will inbound here, and I think they might go look at this one. Erica Porter did take a hard foul that time. And right now they actually signaled number 33 for Buffalo for the foul, and that's Hattie Ogden. But it was Johnson and Porter that were tangled up, and the officials are over at the monitor now. Both teams going to get a chance to go to the benches. An official timeout brought to you by Juniper Brewing Company, our 2023-2024 timeout sponsor of Bowling Green Women's Basketball. So just 27 seconds into quarter number four here. And both teams will get another little break to try to talk things over if they didn't have it set the way they wanted after the third quarter. Before the fourth quarter started, another chance to talk things over here. Cam, you've been in plenty of huddles. If you're in the Bowling Green huddle right now, what's the conversation like in there?
Find a way to get Erica Porter the ball. And then on the defensive side, you need a couple big stops. You're winning the rebound battle right now. Keep doing what you're doing. Don't turn the ball over. Get the ball to Erica. And then I think at some point, I have faith in Amy and Paige Kohler knocking down some big shots.
And it is interesting the way the scoring breaks down for Bowling Green tonight. 44-34. It's a low-scoring game. You know, we've made that apparent and clear all the way through. But Erica Porter has 16 of 32 points, so she accounts for just less than 50% of the scoring for Bowling Green. Beyond that, Sharps has 8, but again, not shooting her best. Amy Velasco, 4 points, shooting 1 of 10, definitely not her best. Paige Kohler has 3 points, and Emily Cecil shooting 100%, 1 for 1 from the floor. And we did just get word from the officials. They went back and looked at that contact to Porter last time down the floor for Bowling Green. They were looking for any additional contact that would have warranted an upgrade of the foul. They didn't see any, so we will just get the foul called. And right now it is going to stand, and it's going to go against Hattie Ogden. So Johnson was upset, but the foul going to be called on her teammate, Ogden, and she picks up her second. Alexis Davis as well, still on the bench for Buffalo with 4 fouls. And this Porter-Johnson matchup has favored Erica Porter.
It'll be interesting to see how they play Davis, how early they want to bring her into the game.
Especially sitting on 4 in what has been a game that has never felt like it's a double-digit game. It stands at 10 right now, but it feels like this one, it really is within a couple of scores.
Felt off put pretty early with the turnovers BG was having, but since then it's been fairly even.
So here we have the whistle. Velasco to inbound from the baseline. They are trying to get it into Porter. Velasco over the top does get it to Erica Porter. Here comes Velasco, the basketball back outside. Sharps trying to step around Lewis Williams, gives it back to Velasco. Here comes Kohler, left side into the corner, the pass to Hill. It was nearly knocked away by the Bulls. Bowling Green able to keep the basketball. 5 on the shot clock. Kohler through the lane, moves it to the corner. Hill for 3 on its way. Too long there. Porter after the basketball, tangled up with Ogden. Last touch by Porter before it goes out of bounds. And both squads will rush to help their player back to their feet. Team effort for both the Bulls and the Falcons tonight. Emily Cecil going to check back into the contest for Bowling Green as Paige Kohler will get a breather here.
Cecil brought some good minutes earlier in the game. She only played 5 minutes, but she did pull up with a 3, which is not the most characteristic of her to do.
Emily Cecil averages less than a point per game so far this year. Did hit one last time out against Northern Illinois. Here comes Chella Watson. Don't let her get hot in the fourth quarter. She'll make you pay. Knocks down a 3 there. Extends Buffalo's lead to 13. Amy Velasco now looks inside. Had to pick up the basketball. Moved it back out. Sharps on the baseline. Back to Velasco. Comes open for a 3 of her own. And Amy Velasco, name that tune as Velasco drops down a 3.
Big shot from Amy. 2 of 11 tonight. 1 for 4 from 3. Good to see her put it down.
Like you said right there, her first 3 of the game. And Bowling Green couldn't have asked for it at a better time. Here goes Rena El Husseini to the inside. Finds Lewis Williams on the baseline. Back out Ogden for 3. Left side. Too long out of her hand. Velasco able to bring in the rebound. Amy Velasco, 5 rebounds tonight. Sharps for 3 on away. Bowling Green was looking for back-to-back, could not hit it. Kirsten Lewis-Williams thinking all the way herself. Barrels through the lane, right-handed opportunity. Could not eclipse the rim, but Rena El Husseini rips it out of the hands of Hill. And now Buffalo immediately going to go away from the perimeter, and they're going to have to blow the whistle here. The clock did not start. El Husseini going to inbound for the Bulls, up 10. They just wanted to make sure they had the shot clock right. Lewis Williams at the top of the key, guarded by Cecil. Gets a screen from Ogden and some separation there. Back out El Husseini. Got Velasco to bite there. A foul going to be called on the floor. Where will it be assessed? It will go against Morgan Sharps. And that's Morgan Sharps' second foul of the game.
El Husseini has been pretty stat-filling tonight. Obviously hasn't scored in a while, but she still comes in with big right there with drawing the foul.
Watson outside, back to El Husseini, going to take a look at the bucket there, trying to get back in the scoring column like you just alluded to. Bowling Green will watch that one as it goes out of bounds after the miss. It was a quick breather for Kohler indeed. She comes back out onto the floor as the Falcons try to manage minutes here down the stretch and keep their bodies fresh. 47-37, Buffalo still leads. 2.5 minutes into the fourth quarter now. We will get a foul called. It will go against Kiara Johnson. A hold there on Erica Porter.
They're really trying to feed Erica, get her off ball screens, get her the ball inside.
Sharps pulls up there off the inbound pass and puts it through. And that shot from Morgan Sharps is so crisp. And on off the dribble this week, Fred Shamil talked about that. He said every time Morgan shoots the ball, you think it's going in. Well, that time was one of those times where it did go in. Porter going to be called for the foul as Kiara Johnson goes inside. And Johnson going to get a chance to go to the free throw line here. Johnson, a 60% free throw shooter on the year. Made both in her first trip to the line. And this is going to be that point of the game where we talked about it in the pregame show. Free throws down the line are going to be crucial, and Johnson misses the first. So here's Johnson's second attempt through her rhythm, able to knock that one down. And here comes Alexis Davis. Coach Burke not going to wait long. 2 minutes and 43 seconds into the quarter before bringing Alexis Davis back in on four fouls. And certainly you'd love to see Bowling Green try to attack Davis here in the next possession or two. Velasco on the outside of the basketball as Bowling Green trails by 9. Kohler fires the Sharps. Down low, they'll go right to Porter. Porter over the top. Make it 9 of 9 from the floor.
Buffalo's doing a smart job of putting Ogden on Porter instead of worrying about Davis's fourth foul. They're playing her on Olivia Hill.
El Husseini off to Watson. Watson thinking about pulling up, going to let it fly, and Watson rattles the cage and finds the bottom of the cup once again. Timeout called by Buffalo. Their lead is back to 10. 51-41, we have another timeout here. Another one of our timeouts brought to you by Juniper Brewing Company, located at 145 South Main Street in downtown Bowling Green, featuring coffee and craft beer, serving breakfast, lunch, and dinner. See the latest menu at juniperbrew.com. Just a 30-second timeout, so we will keep it here. Got to make sure we thank our official timeout sponsor for this season. So Bowling Green will have the basketball here, but down 10, still a tall task for Bowling Green. They're going to need, once again, we talked about it, to come up with some defensive stops, and that's going to be tough to do with Chella Watson coming alive, now the Buffalo leader in scoring with 12.
Watson's only scored 6 points in the second half, but these have been huge 6 points.
Both coming from behind the three-point line for Watson this half. Here is Amy Velasco, the basketball for Bowling Green, going to work on that right side just in front of head coach Fred Chamil. The pass off now, Morgan Sharps back to Velasco, open for three. Velasco looking at it again, and that one off the mark. Alexis Davis the rebound. That's the type of play her presence brings for Buffalo. And Becky Burke going to back her team off and trying to continue to wind some of this time off the clock in the fourth quarter. Time working to the advantage of the Bulls, the disadvantage of the Falcons. Lewis Williams on the outside, gives to Davis, going to try to get around Porter. Davis, a left-handed floater, gets it to go. 53-41. Bowling Green needs offense now. The offense and defense has to go hand-in-hand for Bowling Green. Velasco tries a left-handed layup. El Husseini there for the rebound, and a foul going to be called on Olivia Hill, and that's Hill's third foul of the game.
Davis hasn't done – he doesn't have a super crazy stat line, but her presence in the paint with Erica Porter has been huge, as long as going 100% from the field, 4-for-4 with 8 points.
And we're at that point in this game where for Bowling Green, offense and defense have to go hand-in-hand. You can't have one without the other. 53-41, 5:35 left in the fourth quarter. El Husseini moves it around. Hattie Ogden now on the right side of the basketball. Off to Watson, top of the key. Guarded by Hill. Here's a screen from Davis. Watson gets by, pulls up there from just beyond the right elbow. An offensive rebound for Alexis Davis. She goes back up with the left hand. Left it short, off the front of the iron. Paige Kohler brings in the board. Kohler into the middle. Out to Sharps for three. Morgan Sharps hits one when Bowling Green needs it. Morgan Sharps has not had a great night scoring, but up to 13 points courtesy of another big three ball.
She scored in double figures since January 24th, Brandon.
Back down to single digits is Buffalo's lead. El Husseini squatting away at the hands of Velasco, trying to create some space. 10 on the shot clock. Davis the basketball now. Off to Ogden on the outside, looking down low over the top. Lewis Williams able to get by Kohler and get the points.
Amy Velasco tried to help backside on that, but overplayed it a little bit.
So here's Kohler leading the Falcons up the floor. She'll go right to the Bowling Green bench, and Fred Shamil will call a full timeout. Another one of our timeouts brought to you by Juniper Brewing Company. 55-44, Buffalo leads by 11, 4:34 left to go here in this one. You're listening to Bowling Green Women's Basketball right here on 88.1 WBGU.
Uh-oh, Brad's buzzed.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, he's starting with the woots.
Woot, woot.
And now a speech.
I just want to say that friendship is about heart. Heart and brain. Who's with me?
Good thing is, he knows when he's buzzed.
And my brain is saying, when it's time to go home, somebody call me a ride.
Love that guy.
Me too.
Know your buzzed warning signs? Call for a ride when it's time to go home. Buzz driving is drunk driving. A message from NHTSA and the Ad Council.
Back here at the Stroh Center once again, courtside for this women's basketball matchup between Buffalo and Bowling Green. Buffalo an 11-point lead right now, 55-44, 4.5 to go. Here comes Morgan Sharps inside for Bowling Green, pulls up from the baseline. Here comes the shot from Sharps. Coming around a little bit sharper than it was in the first half. El Husseini the basketball working on Velasco. The pass off to the right side. Lewis Williams there. Trying to go down low to Watson. The avenue wasn't there. Olivia Hill some good defense to Chella Watson. Here comes El Husseini through the lane to the corner. Hattie Ogden the basketball now. Back out Watson. Down to five on the shot clock here. Watson trying to get that separation from Hill. Pulls up just outside the left elbow and knocks it down. Fading away off balance. Watson does it all.
Big shots by Watson. Big shots.
57-46 now. Buffalo does still have that 11-point lead. Kohler on the outside, behind the back transition, trying to get down low, off the glass. Kohler gives it a kiss.
Only her fifth point of the night. Now she's 2-for-7 on the night.
3.5 minutes to go. Becky Burke telling her team to slow it down. Plenty of time for a team that's up 9. Not as much for a team down 9. Watson going to the inside through the double team is going to draw the foul. Foul will go against Olivia Hill. Chella Watson going to go to the free throw line. We talked about her in her earlier appearance in which she went 50% at the line. An 80% free throw shooter on the year. And Watson will tie her shoes. And we kind of talked about her being unarguably right now the favorite for Mid-American Conference Player of the Year. She's been able to do some impressive things this season for Buffalo. had 36 against Bowling Green the first time out, 47 against Toledo. We talked about that as well. But she has just been lighting up the scoreboard game after game, averaging in the mid-20s in points throughout the entire season and Mid-American Conference play. Able to get the first free throw, the second on the way and through as well. Buffalo back out in front by 11. Bowling Green going to need to hurry here. Buffalo getting closer and closer to clinching their spot in Cleveland. Sharps for three straight away. Too long there out of her hands. Porter, an offensive rebound, going to try to go back up, but an offensive foul going to be called on Porter. And actually, they will switch the call. The baseline official came up like he was going to call that an offensive foul and then decided he was going to point to the floor instead. So Erica Porter gets the bucket and an opportunity at the free throw line here to potentially cut this down to an 8-point game. Porter 10 of 10 from the floor, 20 points tonight to go along with 12 rebounds. Cannot get the three-point play. Second time we've seen her have a chance at it. And again, leaves that one at the line.
2 for 4 tonight from the line. Haven't had a lot of chances. Got to capitalize on those.
Here's Watson at the offensive end for Buffalo. Nearly lost the basketball as she tried to make a dribble move between her legs. Lewis Williams looking back to the outside. El Husseini there slowing it down. 2:45 left to play. El Husseini going to drive inside on Velasco, and that was a difficult bucket there for Rena El Husseini, who's got 13 points tonight. Velasco and Sharps back and forth. Velasco trying to get open behind the perimeter. Looking for a three ball here. Bowling Green needs points, down 11. Sharps, the basketball, pulls up right elbow, left it well short of the basket. The air ball finds its way into the hands of Davis. 2:15 left to play. Bowling Green going to press up now. Tighter defense. El Husseini spins around Velasco. Going to go to the corner. Wisely taking time off the clock. Down to 2 minutes left. Foul going to be called on Hill. That'll be her fifth. She is done for the night. So Paige Kohler will come in for Olivia Hill. Sophie Zekin checks in for Erica Porter.
So can't Buffalo, see Erica staying out of the game very long.
No, it does take the first seat on the bench right next to assistant coach Nick DiPillo, and she'll go right back to the scorer's table to check in. So Chella Watson at the free throw line for two. Started 1 of 13 since that time, 4 of 5 from the floor. A chance here at the free throw line to continue to improve upon her scoring line tonight. 16 points thus far. Make it 17 on the first free throw. And what will end up being right around an average scoring performance from Watson, but she'll have essentially done it in a half.
Impressive turning. She's getting hot right at the time.
63-50, Buffalo leads. Bowling Green up the floor after Watson able to hit both free throws. Here's Velasco off to Kohler. Kohler trying to work through the defense. Back out, Velasco, open three-point try. And missed.
Amy's not quite shooting like she normally does. She's 1 for 6 tonight on the season, shooting 43%. She's having a rough one tonight.
And a foul on Paige Kohler, and Buffalo will get to trot to the other end, as that's Bowling Green's fifth foul. So Kirsten Lewis-Williams, third on the team in scoring, 6 of 10 from the floor, has not been to the free throw line yet tonight, but has contributed in just about every way possible. Able to get her first at the line.
13 to 4 free throws, that's a huge margin. Even though it's not even close, last game there was 38 total free throws. There's only been 17 tonight.
Lewis Williams puts it through. It's a 15-point lead for the Bulls. Velasco comes out of the backcourt. The Falcons trying to go fast and furious now. Sharps for three on a line. Rattled the cage but would not fall. Porter back up with it. And she's going to be fouled. Nearly another and one opportunity. But that ball took an unfriendly roll off the rim. So Erica Porter at the free throw line, where she has struggled tonight. Has had two attempts at the line. unable to get either so far. We'll see if she can lock in here. And Porter puts the first one through. And how about it? Kyla Smith for Bowling Green. Back to the scorer's table along with Sophie Zekin and Taya Ellis. Smith checked in for 1.7 seconds in last Wednesday's contest against Akron. Going to get some time on the home floor here for Bowling Green.
Bowling Green's going to have to press, make something happen, get some turnovers, quick points. If they want a shot to get back into it.
So Kyla Smith going to back up her first defensive possession here for Bowling Green at home in the Stroh Center. Chella Watson, the basketball, guarded by Tay Ellis. Watson going to go right to the basket. Foul going to be called on Ellis as Watson goes out of bounds. So Watson at the free throw line. Gets the first here. Trying to make it a 20-point night here if she can hit on the second. 6 of 7 overall from the free throw line and make it a 20-point performance for Chella Watson. She had to grind it out. Checks out for the final time tonight. Handshake there with head coach Becky Burke. Paige Kohler up the floor for Bowling Green. Taya Ellis looking to move the basketball around. Here's Emily Cecil back to Kohler. Long three on its way. Off the iron, El Husseini brings in the rebound. Here's Lewis Williams. And all that's left is for time to come off the clock. Under a minute to play now, and Buffalo going to earn their spot in the Mid-American Conference Tournament. Rena El Husseini knocks down a three once again from the corner. 16 points for her tonight. Kohler the basketball, gets it off to Smith. Now Ellis, the basketball back into the hands of Kohler. Kohler working back behind the perimeter once again. Off to Cecil. Cecil going to bring it inside. Off to Smith. Takes a look at the basket. Kyla Smith knocks one home. Has now officially registered a point as a member of this Bowling Green basketball team. And that will be the last bucket of the game. 70-54. Buffalo going to win this one and advance and clinch their spot in the Mid-American Conference Tournament. 3 games left to go, but still a lot to be determined in terms of seeding. Buffalo does have a tough schedule coming up, but we will step aside. Reminder, coming up in the postgame show, we'll be joined by Bowling Green assistant coach Lexis Grambolinko and our player of the game, Erica Porter. Stay tuned. You're listening to Bowling Green Women's Basketball right here on 88.1 WBGU.
Tom has been a teacher for over 40 years. One day, I think one of the students had asked the question and he didn't remember the answer. And I also noticed that he was letting his class out earlier than they were supposed to let out. I was really starting to worry.
Levi and I talked about how it would change our lives, but he was there beside me.
When something feels different, it could be Alzheimer's. Now is the time to talk. Visit alz.org/ourstories to learn more. A message from the Alzheimer's Association and the Ad Council.
Adopt US Kids presents What to Expect When You're Expecting a Teenager. Learning the lingo.
Jelly. Jelly adjective. Jelly is a shorter, better way to say jealous. As in, Chloe, I am like so jelly of your unicorn phone case.
You don't have to speak teen to be a perfect parent. Thousands of teens in foster care will love you just the same. Visit AdoptUSKids.org. Brought to you by the US Department of Health and Human Services, Adopt US Kids, and the Ad Council.
All the talks we've had over the years, including what you've told me about not using alcohol and other drugs, they stick with me. And believe it or not, they really do make a difference, especially at times that matter most.
Hey, want a drink?
No thanks, I'm good. So thank you, Dad, for talking and preparing me for what's ahead.
Thank you for talking.
For more information about talking with your kids about underage use of alcohol and other drugs, visit underagedrinking.samhsa.gov.
Back here from the Stroh Center following Buffalo's 70-55 victory over Bowling Green, joined now by Bowling Green assistant coach Lexis Graham-Blinko. Coach, take us through your initial thoughts on tonight's game.
Well, we just couldn't make shots, and we, you know, our focus was on, you know, Watson, fourth leading scorer in the nation, but we let three other kids go off, you know, and that's when you focus on one kid, you can't let others go off, and we just didn't do that. We didn't show up today.
Buffalo got out to that early lead, a couple of threes to get this game going, and it really seemed like that set the tone. But we know with this Bowling Green team, we know with your squad, you know, they battle back. They've been through a lot of adversity this season. And it seemed like, you know, in the first half, you did a really nice job keeping Chella Watson in check. But then in the second half, where was that balance, you know, of trying to keep now everybody in check that had already been contributing
to
them?
Yeah, we didn't contest any of their shots. We didn't rebound well. We obviously, if you're not playing, if you're not making shots, if you're not doing what you need to do on the offensive end, you got to make up for it on the defensive end. And we just didn't do that.
So now, we knew this game, what it meant in terms of where the seeding stands right now, but there's still three games left in Mid-American Conference play. And this is a team, A, that you could very well see again in 2 weeks.
Right.
But what does a game like this, you know, coming off the high of two road victories over Akron and Northern Illinois, what does this game mean for the three games moving forward for the end of the season for you guys?
We just got to finish out the rest of the regular season. We got to show up for the next three games, and we got to do what we have to do.
Miami coming up this week. That's a big rematch from earlier in the season as well. And then Western Michigan and Eastern Michigan, two earlier season wins for you guys coming up next week. So the last home game of the regular season against Miami, team you played once before. Can you give us a little glimpse of the game plan going into that one?
Well, it's not my scout. But, no, we just got to defend. And we let kids that didn't really play, you know, show up. And we had a girl that shot two threes, and she hadn't made one all year. But we just got to defend, honestly. That's what we got to focus on for the next 2 days and just be ready to defend on the defensive end and get in the gym and make shots, honestly.
I lied to you because I got one more question for you here.
Okay.
Kyla, at the end of the game, gets in and officially gets a bucket in as a Division I basketball player. A big moment for her.
Yeah, definitely. Big moment. Wish it was a big moment as a win. But, you know, proud of her for sure.
Well, Coach, as always, thank you for your time.
Thank you.
So we will step aside once again from the Stroh Center. When we come back, Cam will be back on the headset. We'll talk some final stats, and then we'll be joined by Erica Porter, our player of the game this evening. You're listening to Bowling Green Women's Basketball right here on 88.1 WBGU.
If you suffer from COPD symptoms like shortness of breath and fatigue, where do you turn? There are medications and oxygen, but do you know about pulmonary rehab? 3 out of 5 COPD patients have never heard of it. Pulmonary rehab is an exercise, education, and support program that gives you tools to manage your condition, and Medicare typically pays for it. So whether it's grocery shopping on your own or just walking across the room, pulmonary rehab can help you. Visit livebetter.org to find out about your options for pulmonary rehab today.
This is Artie Abrego, and you're listening to 88.1 FM WBGU Bowling Green, home of the Falcon Media Sports Network.
Hi, it's Olivia Munn with my shelter pets, Frankie and Chance. Say hi, guys. When I adopted them, I discovered that they both have incredible personalities. Chance's sole purpose in life is to love and to be loved. Frankie is a little bit of a scoundrel and always entertaining. They're a little bit of a lot of things, but they're all pure love. Adopt pure love at theshelterpetproject.org. Brought to you by the Ad Council, the Humane Society of the United States, and Maddie's Fund.
Some knowledge belongs to us and us alone. The way our girlfriends walk, talk, touch their hair. Details that only a sister can know about her girls. But what about our other girls? The ones we carry with us every day. Our bond with our sister girls gives life. But knowing your breasts can save it. Go to knowyourgirls.org for the facts you need on breast health. Brought to you by Susan G. Komen and the Ad Council.
back here as we move along in the Bowling Green Women's Basketball postgame show. A 70-55 victory for the Buffalo Bulls tonight over the Bowling Green Falcons. Just three games to go now in the Mid-American Conference, and Buffalo clinches their spot tonight in the conference tournament in Cleveland. Cam, we take a look back through the stats in this one, and it was really a game that Buffalo set the tone early, and they were able to maintain their pace and sort of their leadership all night long.
100%. Yeah, they started off fast. Bowling Green had almost double-digit turnovers in the first quarter, had seven, I think. And then kind of Bowling Green picked it up for the second and third quarter. In the fourth quarter, they really just put it on, especially with the explosion of points from Watson.
And when we look at the individual scores, Watson only had 4 points in that first half, had 16 in the second half. And you heard me. You were sitting here when I talked to Coach Lexus about the way that Bowling Green had to try to step up and defend. They focused on her early, but that allowed Rena El Husseini and Kirsten Lewis-Williams to get going. And all three by the end of the night, with Watson leading the way with 20 points. Watson, El Husseini, and Lewis-Williams all end up with 14-plus points. So obviously big for Buffalo to get that effort out of those supporting players as well.
Absolutely. Like we talked about before the game with Kirsten, obviously freshman player of the year in the MAC, definitely a huge possibility, especially with the way she's played tonight. Also with El Husseini, she did everything. I mean, 5-for-8 from the field, 16 points, 4-for-6 from 3, 2-for-2 from the line, 8 rebounds, 5 assists, and 3 steals, and was just a defensive presence all night.
Essentially led the team in every category outside of the scoring, which she led for a large majority of the game. On the other side for Bowling Green, they get 22 points out of Erica Porter, 10 for 10. You can't get any better than 100% from the floor tonight for Erica Porter. And in that double-double, 22 points, 13 rebounds, did have a pair of assists as well. But beyond that for Bowling Green was where the questions kind of came. Sharps got going late and ended with 15. Amy Velasco, 2 of 14 shooting tonight, 7 points. Paige Kohler had 5. Emily Cecil made a 3. And then how about Kyla Smith at the end of the game? The club call-up, playing for the Division I basketball program here at Bowling Green due to some injuries suffered by this team throughout the year, gets in, knocks down a 3, and now she has officially scored at the Division I level. Special moment for her.
I can't even imagine. I mean, coming, especially like you said, off a club team, not ever anticipating to get the call-up. I mean, we're seeing all around college basketball now with TCU. We saw it, how they were pulling players from different sports, and we just happened to pull one from the club team and, you know, hit a 3 tonight. It was good, great for her.
Did get in for the second time. Just played a little over a second, a little under 2 seconds in Akron, so it didn't really count. Well, it did, but you know what I mean. And here in this one, able to get the bucket, plays 2 minutes in this game. So big hats off to Kyla Smith, you know, for getting on the floor and getting the bucket here late. And obviously, as Coach said, Bowling Green would have loved to have it in a win, but instead tonight it comes in a loss. So your final thoughts, Cam, on this one? Obviously, 3 games left to go. We talk about the tournament. We're going to continue to talk about the tournament as we get closer, but your final thoughts on this one tonight?
I thought the early turnovers caused a lot of issues for the Falcons, and then also the shooting struggles for Amy and Paige Kohler, I think, really hurt the Falcons in a big way. And then obviously, I think a sleeper that we talked about her all night, but she didn't have as much of a points presence as she did a defensive presence, and I think that was Davis, number 23. I think she, even though most of the points that Erica scored weren't when she was in the game, it was when she was in foul trouble and on the bench. So I think she played a huge part. She came in towards the end, had a couple nice assists, and defensive stops.
And it was almost like as soon as Alexis Davis came in that fourth quarter, she was able to lock up Porter enough to where it prevented Bowling Green from making those little runs that we had seen them make to get themselves a chance at the end. So we will step aside when we come back. Erica Porter, our FMSN player of the game, will be out. And we will get a chance to talk to her about her thoughts from this one after another great individual performance. But I'm sure she'll have some things to say about the team following tonight's tough loss. So Bowling Green loses this one 70-55. Stick around. We've got Erica Porter coming up next. You're listening to the Bowling Green Women's Basketball Postgame Show right here on 88.1 WBGU.
There's so much more WBGU content available online through our social media profiles on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. Subscribe to our feeds to get the most up-to-date information about the program schedule, show hosts, and upcoming promotional events. Return to Radio Freedom with WBGU on 88.1 FM, Northwest Ohio's community radio station.
Melissa from Michigan. I work an extra part-time job serving lunch at my child's school, but I still can't afford to put food on our table.
Daniel from California, choosing whether to pay the rent or pay to fix the car to get to work doesn't leave us with much at all. Now we can't even pay for meals.
Hunger is a story we can end. End it at feedingamerica.org. Brought to you by Feeding America and the Ad Council.
Did you know that people born from 1945 to 1965 have the highest rates of hepatitis C, but most don't know they're infected? People can live for decades without symptoms, but over time, hepatitis C can cause serious health problems, including liver damage and even liver cancer. If you were born from 1945 to 1965, the CDC recommends that you get a blood test for hepatitis C. So talk to your doctor about getting tested. It could save your life. A message from the CDC.
All over America, people are taking the national radon test. Have you? Answer true or false. Radon is a radioactive gas. True.
I didn't know that, no.
True or false. The Office of the Surgeon General recommends that all homes be tested for radon. True, your home should be tested. True or false, radon is the second leading cause of lung cancer. True.
I'm gonna dial the number and call.
1-800-SOS-RADON.
Keep your family safe from radon. Call now.
1-800-SOS-RADON.
Women Heart is in a race to save lives. Heart disease is the number one killer of women. It's 80% preventable if you know the facts. Millions of women are living with or at risk of heart disease. Get educated. See your doctor. Know the facts. To win this race, we all have to do it together. Our hearts beat as one. To learn more, visit womenheart.org.
The average time a resume spends on an HR manager's desk is 7 seconds, and most of them are tossed aside. Now imagine if one of those resumes belonged to Yasmin, who was
living in a shelter, juggling 3 jobs. I had to be resilient. That's something that you can't teach.
We rely so much on a resume, yet it could never tell the full story of someone who
had to be independent and take initiative, and that's how I handle every project I get.
Discover new ways to develop great talent at gradsoflife.org. Brought to you by Grads of Life and the Ad Council.
This is Northwest Ohio's community radio station, WBGU 88.1 FM. Like, follow, and subscribe to our Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter feeds for access to special content, program and DJ information, and so much more. Return to Radio Freedom with the WBGU on 88.1 FM and online social media profiles. Thanks for listening to WBGU Bowling Green.
Welcome back to The Dog Show. Up next, we have Satchmo. Satchmo is a member of the Shelter Pet Group.
That's right, a group known especially for their couch-snuggling, ball-chasing, face-licking, and, of course, companionship. Now, let's see him in action.
Look how he makes eye contact with his person.
That's actually known as the treat stare.
How intuitive, and now he appears to be excitedly turning in circles.
Ah, the happy dance so common with this group.
But really, the best way to know an amazing shelter pet like Satchmo is to meet one.
Visit theshelterpetproject.org today. Adopt.
Brought to you by Maddie's Fund, the Humane Society of the United States, and the Ad Council.
The possibility of lung cancer can be pretty scary, especially if you're one of approximately 8 million current or former smokers at high risk. That's why SaveByTheScan.org wants you to know that now there's a breakthrough low-dose CT scan that can detect lung cancer early, and it only takes 60 seconds. You stop smoking, now start screening. For an easy quiz to see if you're eligible, visit SaveByTheScan.org. It could save your life. SaveByTheScan.org is brought to you by the American Lung Association's Lung Force Initiative and the Ad Council.
Back here from the Stroh Center one final time following Buffalo's 70-55 victory over the Bowling Green Falcons. But we are joined now by our player of the game tonight. Another double-double. Stop us if you've heard that before. 22 points, 13 rebounds. Miss Erica Porter, another fantastic individual performance for you. Congrats on a great game.
Thank you so much.
So when we dive into the team performance tonight, obviously not the result you wanted. What did you feel on the floor like it was the difference maker that led to the result?
One, not finishing plays on offense, and then I think our rotation or help rotation on defense was not really there the whole game. I think we played the personnel well. I just think we had to finish the defensive stop, and I just at the last seconds we just let them score, or we were sleeping on the help defense. Like I said, the help defense I think was kind of not the best.
So let's talk about your play. Obviously, you had the big game tonight. It seemed like there was a much bigger difference in the matchup with Alexis Davis versus the matchup with Kiara Johnson. Can you sort of talk us through that? And I know you guys talk about it all week in Scout, but just talk us through the difference and why you seemed like you were so much more effective on Johnson. What did you try to expose when you were in that matchup?
I think the difference between them two, I think respectfully, like Johnson's a little bit slower on defense than Davis. So, I mean, I know I'm kind of quick offensively and I try to, you know, do my signature one dribble to the middle back baseline or, you know, try to finish off of offensive rebound when they're not aware of where the ball is. And I think I did that really well, just tracking the ball and rebounds and, yeah, just getting putbacks mostly. So
a lot of explosiveness. And yes, we're definitely accustomed to seeing that from you at the offensive end. So we knew what this game coming in meant. We knew it was a battle of 4 and 5 current seeds in the standings. Buffalo locks up their spot in the conference tournament with a win tonight. You guys, I don't think it's a question of whether or not you're going to make the tournament. It's going to be where, you know, the seeding sits after this one. And over the next three games, you guys got some games on the schedule that are very winnable games. A rematch against Miami, who did win in Oxford earlier this year. So a big-time rematch at home, a chance to get a little revenge, if you want to say that. And then matchups against Western and Eastern, two teams you beat earlier this season. So what does this team have to do? What do you and the girls have to do to get on the right foot before the Mid-American Conference Tournament?
Like I've said in the past, I think our starts are very slow. We work really hard in practice against practice guys who are way stronger. You know, they're men. So, you know, they do a great job trying to get us ready. And in practice, we try to execute offensive plays and defensive plays, and I just think we struggle to carry that over into gameplay. Starting off strong and finishing plays, and I think when our shots don't fall, I think we need to learn how to adjust. When things aren't working, I just think we need to adjust. And like I said, just getting defensive stops. Miami's going to be a good one because they're going to come out strong because they know we want to win. So, and then Eastern and Western. You know, we won against them, so they're going to play really hard, so we can't settle for that. We still have to play our game. We still have to play hard and, you know, give the first punches. And I think we'll be well with that. And if everyone plays their role, no one gets out of character, I think we'll be really successful.
Well, Erica, thank you for your time once again, as always, and congratulations on another double-double and a great individual performance for yourself.
Thank you.
So that will do it from us here for at the Stroh Center tonight. Buffalo gets a 15-point victory, 70-55 over Bowling Green. Some thank yous to go out real quick. Henry Costco, the board op, back in the studio. My broadcast partner, Cam Orths, Falcon Media Sports Network Sports Director Steve Iwanek, the Falcon Media Advisor Carl Smith, all of Bowling Green Athletics for this partnership with Falcon Media Sports Network to be on the road and at home for all of Bowling Green women's basketball contests throughout the season. We'll take you through the Mid-American Conference Tournament and hopefully beyond. But I'm Brandon Lowe saying so long. Buffalo beats Bowling Green 70-55. This has been another presentation of Bowling Green women's basketball right here presented by the Falcon Media Sports Network.
This has been a presentation of the Falcon Media Sports Network on 88.1 FM WBGU.